If I stay down here, I've got the hot cook elbow.
Sports Radio 560 WQAM Miami Fort Lauderdale presents the Neil Rogers Show. To talk to Neil, call 567-0560 toll-free for David Broward or #560 on your cell phone. The opinions of Neil, his guests, callers, or anyone else on the show do not necessarily reflect those of WQAM, Beasley Reed Acquisitions, or the Beasley Broadcast Group. Now, Neil Rogers on Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Francisco Arruca is the best radio show on AM. What time is he on?
I don't know.
Every good Christian knows a game to play, and it's not so very hard to do. The name of the game is the Bible says, and you interpret it the way we do. Tell people you know the way. Invite them to your house.
All right.
Take their possessions away, and then you burn it down. You can get somebody to believe anything if you make the Bible say it's true. No matter what you do, you can be guilt-free. The Lord will always forgive you. Pick up a poisonous snake, wave it all around. Find an abortion clinic and shoot a doctor down.
Everybody say that with me, okay?
Beat the crap out of your kids. You're Deuteronomy bound. Go on a pilgrimage and pass the Kool-Aid around. Hide all the chicken heads to make a sacrifice.
Well, these are damn good ribs. I'll tell you that from Tony Romans. It's a good thing that I overheard them on the morning show. Where's the overhead, by the way? Am I deaf or do I just not hear my... Oh, there it goes. Wow. Anyway, these are great Tony Roma's ribs, and we wouldn't even know that they were here, but I was like eavesdropping there, the ass end of the Joe and the Bagel Boy show. You know, that fat boy, that damn Jeff High, if he ever puts that fat pussy of his in the doorway again, kick him out. Kick his fat, porky ass out. What a piece of crap. He comes in there sucking around about ratings, which Mandy Bell brought us ratings that haven't been invented yet from 10 to 2, including the Hispanic numbers. Boy, we got those Hispanic men, or what? We're kicking ass, baby. But in the meantime, the Tony Roma's food that he brings in here, you know, he could have, I'm sure that they were intended for Joe and the Bagel Boys, but how many ribs can they eat? Huh? So luckily, where did you find these, by the way? Did you just appropriate these? They were sitting out in the hallway. Yes. Thank God for that, because if Fat Boy would have known that they were out there still, man, he would have just taken one deep breath and inhaled these bones and all. Fat piece of...
You didn't hear them yelling after me as I ran out of there with that box?
Were they really? Oh, you mean the morning?
Where are you going with that?
Joe and the Bagel Boys? Tough crap. They're starting to learn. They're getting plenty of free food. Yeah, from 6 in the morning till 2 in the afternoon, we know how to get it free. Huh? Yeah. It's later on that they're having a little trouble having to pay for it. And the food, too. Anyway, happy Thursday to you. I'm preoccupied with the ribs. You know, I'm not a big rib guy. Never have been, but it's okay on the Atkins, as if I'm on the Atkins. Am I on the Atkins?
No.
No. Am I losing any weight?
No.
No. But it sounds good. You know, you put on a good act. You don't sit here and eat, Heath Crunch bars or stuff like that while you're on the air. That's a bad example. We're here to try to set a good example for the audience. And today, by the way, is the day of prayer. That's right. It's prayer day in town. And we'd like to invite the audience to call in, say a prayer for me, for George, for anybody, and to any God you want to pray to. You can even pray to anybody you like. Group criticized for inviting Christians only, it says the headline. I don't want to suggest this is another divisive piece of crap, that we have some of these Farbissina Goyim who always invent these things. And then it's kind of embarrassing when they leave the Jews out and the Muslims out and this one and that one and everybody else out. Because I thought this was supposed to bring people together, all this crap. No? So maybe you can say a little prayer for us like Dionne Warwick. George was just telling me that The group 98 Degrees went out there, Littleton, Colorado. Are you sure of that? Where did you hear that?
Pretty sure it was them. If not them, one of the other clone bands just like them.
Wasn't Five. They're British.
No, it wasn't Five.
NSYNC?
It was either them or NSYNC, but I'm pretty sure it was the
98 Degrees.
Which is the one that's got the guy with the really ugly hair in a ponytail, looks like a gangster?
NSYNC.
That's them.
Oh, thank God it wasn't 98 Degrees. They're good. And the lead singer, man, he looks real good. I mean, he looks real. Well, we don't want to get into that. Do we want to get into that?
Yes.
Yeah, he does. I mean, NSYNC blows, and Five from England, they ought to send them back on the banana boat that they came in on. They suck. And of course, last night on MTV, they had the new Backstreet Boys video, which they claimed was a world premiere, which I already saw in Amsterdam and already saw on TV Espanol from España, like I told you. But nevertheless, it's American. You can lie a lot to the public here, especially those silly little hormonal girls that are like dripping all over themselves. God. Watching them is embarrassing, and then realizing that I'm getting all excited about the same video that they are, that's really embarrassing, isn't it?
No.
No, not at all. Is it, Nick? No. He's starting to look pretty good, you know what? What? It goes to show you the wonders of makeup. If they can make Ricky Martin look that good. His video was number 4 on MTV last night. See, this is what happens when there are no hockey games on. You start, you're desperate to find something to watch. That's the 9 to 10 hour on MTV, I guess, is the only hour when they actually show any videos. I mean, what kind of a music video channel is that when they got all these stupid programs on the rest of the time? Beavis and Butt Breath and Ren and Stimpy and all this other crap. When are they ever going to put some damn videos on there? That's what we all want to see. We want to see 98 Degrees, baby. And then come to find out that John Pena stole that CD we had in here of 98 Degrees, allegedly for his daughter. That's what they all say. Just like Lee J. Cobb, remember in Exorcist? Oh, yeah, it's for my daughter. I lied. It was for me. Can I have your autograph? Yeah. Here's Pompano. Hello. Is this phone screwed up again? Because it's got that dark coloration to it again. Although it does say Pompano. I think our phone screwed up again.
Well, the Beast was in here last night.
Well, what, look at that. I can't even get it off. I can't get rid of it.
Am I going to have to pull the plug again?
Oh, you know something? If our program director is listening down the hall here, I'm sitting here with all these big numbers that we got. Can't we get people out of here? What do you mean the Beast was in here again last night? Doing what?
Watching Channel 69 and dubbing off heat highlights.
And
this
diddling
is
around with our equipment again. This phone worked fine yesterday. Look at that. I can't even get the goddamn thing off of there, much less get it on the air. So hang on, Pompino, or not, as the case may be. Oh, listen to that. There we go. Uh-oh, wait. Hold on a second. We're adjusting. Hang on. Okay. That cleared all those pain-in-the-ass callers off there. So call in right away, and let's see if we can get you on the air, even if you have nothing to say. Come on. 5670560. It's equipment adjustment time on the highly rated Neil Rogers show here on QAM. What did I tell you about having a lock on the door and keeping these people out of here, and now you tell me that goddamn that asshole Bob McKay that you hate like poison from Kiss is going to be having his whole crew in there over the weekend?
He's my best friend.
You hate him like poison. Almost as much as you hate Steve Noodleberg. WQAM.
Phone check.
Thank you. Okay, that's it. All right, everybody else get out of here unless you got something to say. Thank you, sir. We got line checkers. We got phone checkers. Thank you very much. The phone actually works now. This is part of the show. Just to pencil it in as a regular part of the show every goddamn day when you work for this bogus place. I was saying to George before the show today, I'm looking at these amazing numbers that we finally extrapolated 10 to 2. And by the way, Tom Jicha is going to be on for Ed Kaplan after the hockey game tonight. You know Tom Jicha?
He's bloody stupid!
Yeah, that one. Maybe somebody ought to leave him the numbers, okay, so he doesn't have any excuse not writing about this great winter book that the whole QAM station had, since he's supposed to be our good friend and fills in and consorts with Ed Kaplan every now and then, like tonight. Wouldn't it be nice, since he's our one great white hope that might write something about us, to give him these numbers? God. Am I ever going to work for a station in this town that really wants to go out and promote?
No.
That really, is proud of what we got on the air and go out there and do billboards and the massive...
No.
No, only Paxson did that. When they first had the IOD, remember those days?
Yeah.
And we had that gigantic fall book, that first thing under Paxson. Billboards all over the goddamn place, and they were good ones, too. Remember those days? And then when they found out I was leaving, they said, oh, let's put up some more Neil billboards. And everybody went kind of like, yeah, what's that all about? Well, that was that Harry Penis. Never trust a guy named Harry Penis, I'll tell you that right now. 10 minutes after 10 at 560 WQM. It's prayer day. Baruch atah Adonai, manishtah halala hazeh, badabit, badabup, badabup. Come on, let's do it. God's listening. Ain't he listening?
No.
No. Are you looking for fast, easy, reliable access to the Internet? The name you ought to think about is Mindspring. No more of those stupid busy signals. No more of those idiotic ads that you have to say no to all the time. You just hop on there immediately, if not sooner, every time you want. In fact, Mindspring was voted the best Internet service provider by PC World and PC Computing magazines for 1998. So for fast, easy, reliable access to the Internet, the only name you ought to even be thinking about is Mindspring. Just like I've been using for about a year and a half now. No pain, no strain, no busy signals, no ads, no hassle. Pick up the phone right now and call Mindspring, 1-888-M-SPRING. Tell them that Neil Rogers told you to call. They'll waive their usual $25 startup fee, give you the first 30 days of service free from the day you sign up. Mindspring, 1-888-M-SPRING, the very best Internet provider in the universe.
This is 560 QAM.
Esta es el show de la mañana con Neil Rogers. Esta es su cerebro. ¿Tienes preguntas?
Tonight, it's cops in Pennsylvania Dutch country.
Amish cop, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when their carriage comes for you?
Well, hello there, Jebediah.
Hello, Officer Hezekiah. Say, what brings you up to my humble abode?
Well, we got us some reports of some fussing and abusing in these here parts.
Ah, yes, Hezekiah, I'm ashamed to admit that my wife, Sarah, exposed part of her ankle.
Why, that no good hussy.
Yep.
I've got me a good mind to put her in the stocks and give her 40 lashes.
Well, that would be a good idea, but then there wouldn't be anyone to milk the cow.
Yep, women. They're the reason we're all going to hell.
Yep. Well, I gotta get back to plowing the fields.
Okay, then. I guess I'll be getting back to the barn raising, Hezekiah.
Amish cop, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they shackle you?
That's tonight on Cops in Pennsylvania Dutch Country.
10:15 at 560 WQM. Hank Goldberg at 2 o'clock. Jim Matt at 6 o'clock, 7:45. We got playoff hockey, the Bruins and the Sabres. Yeah, that should be real exciting. And then after the game, we got that bald-headed Tom Jicha. Call him up tonight, by the way, those three of you who will be listening after the hockey game, and say, where's that article about the ratings and how great QAM did, the whole goddamn station in this winter rating book, since you're supposed to be the radio TV expert in this town, and you don't write a goddamn word about the rating books, you piece of little bald-headed turd, you? Yeah, we're getting real sick and tired of that crap. You know, Tom, we're sick of it. We're nauseated by it. We're revolted by it. Now, where's he going to be doing the show? Hopefully over in there, right? He's not going to be over here, potching around with our phone. Here's Miami. Hello.
Oh, my God, I'm on?
Yes, sir.
Jeez, I can't believe it. How you doing, Neil?
Why not?
Oh, well,
it's only 7 minutes and 9 seconds. And the only reason you're on is because I'm busy eating now, and otherwise that's why I'm taking calls.
Oh, good.
Otherwise, I would be talking about the important crap. Yes.
Yeah, well, you know, question.
Oh, gee, the Dow is down 90 points already? Christ.
Oh,
we better
God.
Start praying a lot harder, man.
Jeez, maybe the phone line might go. I don't know. You like Andrea Bocelli? I don't.
I hate Andrea Bocelli.
Why are they playing that commercial every time?
Because they're buying the spots. What do you mean, why are we playing it? We don't give a crap whether we like him or not.
QAM.
Don't hear any spots on here for the Backstreet Boys in 98 Degrees, do you? No, so we got to take whatever we get.
Jeez. How about Celine Dion?
How about Celine Dion?
Yeah, with the...
Is that like... Yeah, that's my comment to that. That's the end of breakfast.
Oh, well.
Why, you like Celine Dion?
Oh, no, I like...
She couldn't
sing
her way out of a paper sack. If you put a gun up her ass, she couldn't sing.
You know, I'm in my
20s. In fact, the only sad part of it is that they didn't have her ass on the Titanic.
I'm in my 20s, and I like that music. It just seems to be so powerful. You know,
powerful what? In other words, you're getting wrapped up. Are you getting wrapped up in the hype? Is that what it is? Next thing you're going to be telling me you like Ricky Martin, too.
Oh, I love Ricky Martin. Julio Iglesias and Enrique Iglesias.
You like Ricky Martin?
Huh?
You like Ricky Martin?
I don't like him. I like his music.
Well, like what? La Copa de la Vida? And that awful new song of his, Living, they have to be loco to buy this record?
I don't like that song. I like the Spanish music. Vuelve. I like Vuelve.
Vuelva? Vulva?
Vuelve.
Yeah.
Enrique Iglesias, Vivir.
Now
like
you're talking.
Music.
Yeah, Enrique's great, in spite of what George says. George is just jealous because I got the hots for Enrique's.
Oh, you should.
How about Luis Miguel?
Yeah, I like him. Isn't he from Puerto Rico?
Yeah. Okay, you're out of material, pal. Get out of here. You know something? These Hispanic numbers are really going to go way up. You think they're good now? Wait till you see after yesterday's Cinco de Mayo show. We're going to start getting those Mexican numbers way up. Huh? See, I don't know why you make that. Well, I do know why, because you're a hard-headed little okay? Always putting down Mexicans. Mexicans are a fine people. They never stole a freight train, maybe a few wallets and watches.
And they never stole a radio either, so we don't have anybody in the audience.
We don't. In other words, you're telling me we don't have one Mexican listening right now? We
might have two.
Yeah. Two.
The Oversteers at the labor camp.
I do like that song. Luis Miguel. Two. La misma. Whatever that thing is. Come on, let's hear from a Mexican. We'll dispense all the other proceedings right here while we wait to hear from a real honest to God. Not somebody that married a Mexican or that once had Taco Bell. A real honest to God. WQAM. There you go.
That was one of the little gay boys.
No, it wasn't.
You heard him.
What?
That accent?
That was a Mexican.
Oh, Mexicans spike everything up at the end of their sentences.
WQAM. Mexican line.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Are you Mexican?
Yes, how are you doing?
Okay, phony accent. Okay. Sorry, getting phony. I'm looking for a real Mexican. How you doing, okay? What's he doing? Is a poor man's Pancho Gonzalez routine? Now, cut the crap. Speak like a Mexican. Walk like an Egyptian and speak like a Mexican. That's what we demand here today, okay? Butch up a little bit, you idiots. Have we got one? Have you got a Mexican on there, like a real one? He's overwhelmed. WQAM. All right, now we had a real one. There you go. You're right, there's no Mexicans down here. But boy, there sure is a lot of other spics. Look at this. Now, the young spics, they're listening, but they're too homophobic to put it down. They're too much in a closet. But once they get past 25, they all come flying out of the closet, evidently. Like the guy that said, because you got to be light in the loafers to put down, you're listening to this show, that asshole that called and made those comments. By the way, men 25 to 54, that is men, Anglo, and Spick, everybody else, we got an 11.8 share between the 10 and 2. I just thought I'd mention that for those who keep track. And maybe Tom Jicha, who I'm sure is listening, even though he would deny it, like those young Spicks. Look at this. Hispanic men 25 to 44 between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m., Power is number one with a 9.6 share, and the Neil Rogers Show is second with an 8.1.
Oh. Woo!
25 to 44 Hispanic men were number dos. And if you think that's impressive, men 35 to 44 Hispanic, which is a little bit too old for my taste, but nevertheless, we'll take them. Men 35 to 44, we are, well, where's the damn thing? Oh, you know, I was going to play.
It is so hard.
Because I think that's the name of that 98 Degrees record. Yeah, something like that. It is so hard.
We're number one, damn it!
In Hispanic men, 35 to 44. Boy, that is, with an 11.1, Radio Ritmo's got an
8.0.
So we're like a number one by a mile in that demographic. And even 25 to 54 Hispanic men. Where the hell is it? 25 to 44. 25 to 44 were number one. Hispanic. Are you listening to that? 25 to 44 with a 7.0. Oh, I'm looking for it. It's right there on top of the list. God damn it.
We're number one, damn it.
25 to 49 were tied for first with life. Oh, that's not the right. That's I knew I was in the wrong thing as soon as I saw life. As in get one. 25 to 49 with number 5. I'm looking for 25 to 54 Hispanic men, please. Here it is, number 5 with a 5.8. And when you look at the other stations that were up there with like Radio Amor and CMQFM and Power and Radio Ritmo and Radio Mambi, we're the only English-speaking hope for those Julios in this town. I'll tell you that right now, boys and girls. Thank God. You want to say a prayer? Thank God for
it. Oh, God.
Right. Try to break these people out of that one-dimensional banana boat mentality of theirs. And like I said, if we could just get those Mexicans calling in right now, get the Mexicans on board, we could have like double digits in every Hispanic demographic. And not only that, but don't you remember the day I was asking about Hispanic females, young Hispanic, 18 to, and the phones lit up like crazy? And they were actually on there? Not phony voices like we're getting make-believe Mexicans today. I'm talking real honest-to-God young ladies that were addressed. Well, or something close. WQAM. Hello?
Hey.
Yes, sir.
All right, let me try to read it. I want to talk to you about yesterday, the topic on niggers.
The topic on niggers?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Well, you know, I grew up playing sports with these guys. You know,
with what guys? With niggers?
Yeah. And, I mean, it's totally common for them to call each other, you know, by that name.
Nigger, yeah.
And the worst offender.
Doesn't it sound bad to you when you come on there and say the topic was niggers? That just sounds.
Well, it is kind of.
Now that we've said it 3 or 4 times, it doesn't sound as bad. You're right.
Right, but I mean, the thing that really drives me crazy.
About
is,
what, niggers?
Yeah, the way they get all up in arms when a white person uses the word, but you know, like you said, they call each other that all the time, and the worst offenders are the black women towards the black men.
That's, oh yeah.
It's amazing.
And you ain't getting no to you, nigga.
That's it.
Yeah.
You know, every third word is, you know, is that word, and
is nigger, yeah.
And they get upset when we use it. I don't think they understand what we mean. It's, you know, I mean, I know white.
Well, what do you mean when you call a black guy a nigger? What do you mean?
What I mean is a person that I consider to be a scumbag. Now, I will tell you that I know a lot of white people that I would classify as niggers.
As niggers, yeah.
And
okay,
I think,
now, wait a minute. After we get done talking to Mexicans, we're going to be having white niggers calling in. That would be good.
Hey, as far as your Mexican,
I gotta throw these ribs away. I mean, do you want the rest of these? I'm eating too many of them.
Yeah, right.
I think that guy that called in earlier with that screaming was Speedy Gonzalez.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the cartoon character.
Yeah, I remember Pat Boone had that song, Speedy Gonzalez, and we hate Pat Boone. So have a great day, sir.
You too.
And don't say the N-word anymore, as in nigger. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that word. If it's a word that other people use, we can say it too. Okay, we want to share. Although we don't want no collard greens and grits, although a little watermelon ain't bad. And I do like the Zinger sandwich they have at Kentucky Fried. You ever have one of those? Without the bread, of course. Huh? You never had a Zinger sandwich? Well, it's better than the other crap they got over there. You know, that real deep-fried stuff that's real bad. Like I said, 567-0560, #560 on the Mobile One line. Your people out of control today, mister. Just picking up where they left off yesterday. Out of control. Which, in fact, after hearing that, makes me think, oh, and let me, it's got so much stuff going on again here today, the Francisco Arruca thing. The reason I played that at the beginning of the show this morning, I'm sure most of you did not see it in the paper since most people don't read a goddamn newspaper. Pro-dialogue exiled to air views in English. Francisco Arruca, a South Florida radio commentator who raises the ire of hardline Cuban exiles, will broaden his program to an English audience next month, 8 to 9 a.m. weekdays on Waxy 790 beginning June 1st. Francisco Arruca. What time is he on?
I don't know.
Yeah. One of the great calls in the history to show you what this town is all about. She says he's the best talk host in this town, and I ask her, what time is he on? I don't know, huh?
I don't know.
Yeah. You silly bitch. You're what's wrong with this town, honey. That's probably the broad that's censoring cigar magazines over there at the airport, that miserable, smelly bitch. Somebody ought to stick a cigar in her
rectum.
Probably enjoy it. Give her a little Monica action there.
The screamer?
Yeah. What's his number?
305.
Yeah.
438-0217.
Oh, he's a screamer? 438-0217, yeah.
Area code 305.
Right, in Dade County. Well, maybe you'd like to call him and scream at him a little bit. Keep him busy today, since he's called us, what, 420 times in the last 2 days? Little piece of crap, little piece of turd burger. 26 after 10 at 560 WQM, you know, money. All right.
Dear Alanis, I don't know if you remember me, but I was the guy whose house you set on fire last year.
Uh-huh.
God, I miss you, even though you blew up my car and cut all my hair off. I miss you, girl. But one quick question, do you think you could let me know when you might let me out of this pit? No one's fed me for weeks, but I'm not complaining. Don't misunderstand me, because I love you with all my heart. But if you happen to see my mother, please let her know I'm not dead yet. Dear Atlantis, I want to tell you that the guy you saw with your best friend, that wasn't me. He might. might have looked and talked just like me, but that's surely purely coincidental. I was nowhere near that place. I love you too much to look at anyone else. Here it is. I had a dentist appointment that day, and I was nowhere near the Sheraton Meadowlands Hotel. I would never cheat on somebody who treats me so good and wins all those Grammys, has all that money. Hey, come on, let me out of the pit, will you?
No.
1033 at 560 WQM. Put the lotion back in the basket. Maybe we'll let you out. 18 to 34 men. This is in the from 10 to 2. This is not Hispanic. This is overall all men, 18 to 34. Number one is Power 96 at midday with 11.6. Number two is...
Oh, God!
With a 10.4 share, 18 to 34.
Oh!
See, the only part that we are weak on is the 18 to 24 part. And you want to know why we're weak on 18 to 24? Because we're on...
AM.
We're on AM. Do teenagers and 18 to 24-year-old people listen to AM radio?
No.
No. They don't even know from AM. They don't know where to find it, and your AM as well. I'm serious. They haven't got any idea what it's all about. If we were on FM, I would just say conservatively think it just double the numbers. If we were on FM, right? Instead of an 11.8 in men, the 25-54, we'd have a 23.6. Easy. Am I right?
Uh-huh.
No question. Being on some, and not only being on AM, but being on this, way down on the end of the dial. No, seriously, I mean, like 940, leave it to Queer Channel and Paxton to screw that deal up. 50,000 watts, they're right in the middle of the dial, and they got other than Rick and Putt in the morning who are getting a little bit of a number, other than that, they're in the crapper. But with us, you got to make a special effort to come, like Bob Barker says, or a Rod Roddy, whoever it is, come on down, you know. You got to come down all the way to the end of the dial, the bitter end. And, of course, if you're in just the wrong part of town and the overhead, electrical wires or anything, where there's a goddamn fluorescent within 100 yards of where you are, you know, that's what you hear on AM. So I'm pretty goddamn proud of this accomplishment, whether you believe me or not. Do you believe me?
No.
No. Am I proud to work here on this?
No.
Here's a call from Tampa. Hello.
How you doing, Neil?
Okay, sir.
My father was Mexican. My mother, Czechoslovakian. We don't all sound like typical beasts.
Like that.
Absolutely. The reason I'm calling is, have you ever been to Biloxi?
No.
You want to check out the new hotel there by the people that made the Treasure Island Mirage and stuff? It's called
no.
The Beau Rivage?
Yeah.
It really is special. It's probably...
No.
I'm not going.
No.
In fact, the people that own Pompano Park now, they also own one or more of the casinos over there in Biloxi, and they're always saying to me, if you ever want to go over there, we'll get your freebie, set you up, whatever you want. And I always say,
no.
No.
Well, the
I mean, I realize that. Now, let me ask you this. How do you get from, you're in Tampa, but how would you get from, like, here to there? I'm sure that there's no nonstop flights.
Yeah, right to Gulfport Biloxi Airport. It's AirTran from St. Peter's. It leaves here from St. Pete. They got a St. Pete airport also.
Yeah.
And it goes, it's like a 45-minute flight to Gulfport Biloxi. And then it's, we've been meant to maybe five or six of the hotels there on the last trip. And by far, the Beau Rivage is the nicest. I mean, it's the only Vegas-class casino in the entire place. The rest of them are kind
of... Yeah, I just have this ingrained prejudice against the Deep South. So when I hear Gulfport or especially Biloxi, Mississippi, I just, I cringe.
You know, but like...
But when I was on the train and they said, this train is now in the hands of the Detroitman police, I just got very nervous, you know?
And I have a shameless request.
Yes, sir.
Last week, while you were gone, George played a thing with Phil Henry and Lee Ermey. You know which one I'm talking about?
Phil Henry and Lee Ermey?
Yeah, Lee Ermey, he was the drill instructor from Full Metal Jacket. He was in that movie. And George played an interview with them that he had. I don't know if it was actually Phil and the guy or just Phil doing a voice. But if you had that, I'd love to hear it again. I'd like to do it.
George is shaking his head like he don't know what you're talking
no,
about.
No, I played it. We have
what?
I'm shaking my head because you don't know what the man's talking about.
No. Oh, I know which cut that is. Yeah. Okay, listen, have a great day. I'll see you in Clearwater.
Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, you can't play it off the disc, though.
Why not?
Heavy bleeping had to be done to that thing.
Oh, well, I'm not going to do that. Okay, here you go. You like it?
But I've got it bleeped.
Are you sure?
Okay. 5670560, pound 560 on a mobile one line. It's prayer day. In fact, here's a letter to the editor, another one of those stupid letters to the editor in the Sun Sentinel this time. Roger Stewart in Davie says, religious void at heart of senseless violence. Many people are asking why these senseless acts. You need look no farther than a high school biology textbook or watch the Discovery Channel. The message, kids, you are nothing more than an accident of nature. Your life has no meaning because meaning comes from purpose, and since the universe is only an accident, there is none. According to David L. Wheeler, biologist, humans are not evolution's most important results. Bacteria are. Abraham Lincoln made a prophetic statement, and we have seen its fruition. Remove Bibles from the schools and you replace them with police. By the way, separation of church and state is not in the Constitution or any official document put forth by the Founding Fathers, Roger Stewart and Davy says. Another one of these simplistic answers to all of these problems. In other words, if they just put the prayer back into school, there was another letter just like this in a paper yesterday. Well, since 1962, when it took prayer out of the school, that's when all hell has broken loose. Did you pray in school? Well, forget about you. You're not old enough.
We had silent meditation when I went to elementary school.
Well, when I went to school, which is pre-graduated high school in 1960, Canandaigua Academy, which was a great school with very, very high, a lot of us in the National Honor Society, a lot of us were geniuses then. I don't know what happened in the meantime. Did we pray in school?
No.
No. Did we have a bunch of murderers and rapists and people bringing guns and knives to school?
No.
Doesn't have a goddamn thing to do with prayer, sir, and all you other nutcases with your simplistic solutions to this barbaric, grotesque behavior. God damn it. Just like we got two great stories. Joe Costello pointed out one I missed yesterday. Well, we were busy with Cinco de Mayo yesterday. Driver plows through daycare playground. This is in Costa Mesa, California, and kills two little kids. 3 and 4 years old. We'll get to these. And then, of course, the other one, closer to home, Joseph Cotto killed those two old people. They arrested him yesterday. And when they asked him, why did he do it, he said, I was in a killing mood. He was in the mood, okay? Like Glenn Miller says, in the mood. Remember Glenn Miller? He's dead, too, by the way. Wasn't he killed in the war? What?
I don't know.
WW2, Glenn Miller.
I liked him, though.
No, you didn't. You didn't like Glenn.
Swing music, sure.
Swing this. Oh, by the way, speaking of that, how about swing clubs? We never got our spy report from 2 nights ago on Channel 10, which I did not watch that thing. Since, number one, there was a hockey game on, and number two, I wouldn't watch Channel 10 News if they paid me by the minute. How come we got no spy reports on their big... Since it's sweeps week now, and, of course, the TV stations are capitalizing with all the sex stuff that they can put on there. Oh, people are wife-swapping. Oh, the police have a right to... You know, I mean, come on. Jesus. Like this morning, they got a guy on from Oklahoma from the tornadoes, one of the victims, in a hospital. He's got tubes in his nose. They're interviewing him from a hospital bed. You see that? Well, how are you feeling, pal? You going to go out and, you know...
He quit smoking.
Play a couple rounds of golf today or what? Jesus Christ. To say that the media is sick is such an understatement that it's just mind-boggling. Talk about idiotic questions. Well, how do you feel now that your kids got killed? You feeling okay? How are you going to get through this? Got anything comforting to say? 20 before 11 at 560 WQM.
Start your mornings with a sippy from 560 WQAM. Starting this Monday, it's 4 hours of sex talk with Karen Kay and Wally Sabo.
Oh!
6 to 10 a.m. Monday through Friday, only on 560
All right.
WQAM.
Tonight, I got the feeling that something ain't right.
No.
Put on a yarmulke and don't take it off.
Yeah.
If you see your rabbi, say mazel tov. Schmucks to the left of me, putzes to the right. Here I am, stuck in a temple with you. Well, I'm stuck in a temple with you. And I'm wondering what it is I should do. I don't want to pray at the wailing wall. And I know that I don't like my ball. Schmucks to the left of me, puffs to the right. Here I am, stuck in a temple with you. Well, you're in your daddy's business, but you claim that you're a self-made man. Uncle Si comes over, asks you for a bagel and cheese.
What happened to Kinky, by the way? We haven't seen him since I told him that his baby picture was up there. Not his baby picture, but the same baby.
Oy.
No, seriously, we haven't seen him since that day, I don't think. Since he brought in the picture of his baby, and I said, oh, God, what an ugly kid.
Maybe he's taking care of business.
That'll teach people to bring me baby pictures to look at, okay? I mean, so maybe I'm a hardened old bastard. I don't think so. I just think that most babies are pretty ugly. Huh? Aren't they? Let's be honest about it. There are very few cute babies. Most babies are, like, misshapen and, like, and you say, gee, I hope they stop looking like that real fast. And everybody's always, oh, look at my baby pictures. No, I don't want to look because I'll say something wrong and you get all upset. Here, you want to hold them? No, I don't want to hold them. In fact, remember Disney at the airport? That's before your time in Chicago. He was there with his baby in the airport holding his little baby. He said, oh, here, Neil, do you want to hold him for a minute? Why do I want to hold his baby? And, of course, I had had that stroke, luckily, not too long before that. I said, no, I still got this weak arm, you know. I don't want to drop your little kid here at Midway Airport. Let's try it at O'Hare instead. Oh, Jesus, by the way, the ribs that we had a minute ago, that was just a prequel to lunch. Everything, we got the prequel now because here's the real lunch. John Penis there, who stole my 98 Degrees album, by the way, the CD. Did you take that for your punky little girls? Ah, he gave it. See, you guys, you got more stories. First you tell me that you never said Steve Nodelberg was an asshole. Now
right.
That he came to back to work here.
I did tell him that he could take the 98 Degrees because you didn't want it. It was in here for a year, that disc.
Yeah. Now they're hot.
They're cute.
Even John Tina says they're cute. Oh, boy, that's the end of him. I hope his wife ain't listening today. That's the end of him. Yeah, the one of them, the lead singer, is real cute. The one that's naked in that video that I saw last night. We better start looking. How come if we had a woman audience on this show, then we'd have calls about 98 degrees. I mean, we've got a few queens out there, but that's beside the point. I'm just trying to find out the name of that song. That it's big.
It is so hard.
Something like that. I was watching their video last night, and I was thinking the same thing. I was thinking...
It is so hard.
And the video, too. But we don't have that. So we got a nice lunch here today from our friends at Unsubbed. And, of course, we don't want to get Chuck all nervous across the street at the Sub Center. These people are way downtown. They're down there by the courthouse in downtown Miami. So they're not going to put you out of business, Chuck. Just relax. Take a deep breath. We're not shining you. No, didn't I ask you that? I'm loyal, even though Chuck, he don't need to be buying any spots on his show. He can't afford like those cheap cigar spots, you know. That Footy's telling everybody about. You know, Footy, you're such an asshole. You're such a piece of pus. Y100's a perfect place for you where the average age is like fetus level. That's the median age of the listening audience on Y100. Since Tanner left that place, it's never been worth a crap. Oh, by the way, speaking of Tanner, our sales manager, she's running around telling everybody she wants him to come back here as program director. Did I mention that lately? Well, I mean, it's a long time ago she said that, but I'm just bringing it up again to stir up crap. Because if anybody deserves crap, she's the one. Spoken to her lately, by the way?
No.
Seen her lately?
No.
That's why I'm in such a good mood. That screw and bitch. Driver plows through daycare playground, kills two toddlers in Costa Mesa, California. A man who told police that he wanted to execute innocent children plowed through a daycare center playground with his car, killing two toddlers and injuring five people, authorities said on Tuesday. When the big Cadillac finally came to a stop, pinning several children underneath, the man calmly sat behind the wheel until police arrested him. Stephen Allen Abrams, 39, of Santa Ana, was arrested for investigation of murder and assault with a deadly weapon after driving his car to the Southeast Early Childhood Learning Center schoolyard on Monday. Sierra Soto, 4, and Brandon Wiener, 3, were killed. Nicholas McCarty, 2, and Victoria Sherman, 5, were in critical condition with head injuries, and a teacher's aide, 24, Danielle Necht, was in fair condition with a broken leg. At the daycare center, an angry crowd of neighbors, parents, and workers from a nearby church jeered as Smith was led away in handcuffs. A shrine formed at the school, a mount of bouquets, balloons, stuffed animals, and cards. A cross erected in the playground read, "Dear God, please protect our children." Well, he ain't doing a very good job of it, I'll tell you that right now, okay? He's not doing a real good job, either in Littleton, Colorado, or out there in Costa Mesa, California. He's not protecting children, and he's also not protecting old people. Because right here in town, on the front page of both of your newspapers, by the way, in the darkness, police said, Joseph Cotto hovered over the bed where the elderly couple slept, their chests rising and falling with each breath. His hands were gloved in white athletic socks to keep the blood from his skin. He don't like blood. It was the mood he was in that brought him there in the first place with a kitchen knife in each fist, one in each fist. I was in a killing mood, Joseph Cotto, 17, would tell detectives after they arrested him late Tuesday night. Oh, by the way, to go back to the other story, before the guy went ballistic and drove into the school, he had been, let's see, where is it? Come on, where the hell is this? Oh, yeah, it says 45 minutes before the schoolyard killings, he rammed his car into another vehicle that had cut him off on a freeway. So don't be cutting people off on the freeway, Spigot, because God only knows what kind of aberrant things they're going to do after that. As if that somehow explains to us he was pissed off and fired up and decided to drive into a nursery school and kill a bunch of kids. But anyway, getting back to Joseph Cotto here in town, who says he was in a killing mood, that's why he broke in through the jealousies of his next-door neighbor's window, police said. That's why he stood in their house for 2 hours, working himself up until he seethed with anger and waited for the couple to wake up. And that's ultimately why he stabbed John Joseph Holsneck, 78, over and over again after a brief struggle. And that's why when Mary Rose Holsneck, 77, awoke during the commotion, he stabbed her too and slashed both their throats, police said. When the killing was over, Joseph Cotto, a middle school dropout who lived with his parents next to the Holsnecks for about 2 years, put his bloody clothing in a plastic bag. Then he put an extra pair of jeans on he had brought with him and one of John Holsneck's shirts from the closet. Stabs this guy 50,000 times, kills him and his wife dead, and then he puts the guy's shirt on. He washed his hands with cologne in the bathroom sink and sprayed cologne into the air conditioning vent. He put a towel in the crack under the door to prevent the stench of death from spreading. He didn't like the smell of blood, he told police. So he was spritzing a lot of cologne and, making sure he covered up pretty good. But if we just prayed a lot, you know what I'm saying? If they would have just put the Ten Commandments over the door there at the Holsnecks' house, maybe he wouldn't have done this. You believe that? Yeah. And God is supposed to be looking out for those children and also for these old people, these senior citizens, and everybody else in between. Is he doing it?
No.
He's doing a crap-ass job, I'll tell you that right now. And we're supposed to be, this is supposed to be prayer day. He must need a hearing aid. Let's get a miracle ear for God, okay? Because he ain't hearing you too good. Maybe he don't speak your language. Maybe that's the problem. Maybe he speaks some other kind of a goddamn language. Maybe he's from, like, Dade County. No speaking English. Whatever it might be. God damn it. Here's Miami. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Neil.
I'm listening.
Oh.
Speak to me.
I just came back from Vegas.
Yeah.
The best crap rock and the best kishka is in the stage delicatessen in the forum shops.
In where? In the forum shops? There's a stage deli? I didn't know that.
Yes. It is the best.
Huh.
It's like you're being in heaven. And also, M&M chocolate is manufactured by M&M Chocolates. It's owned by M&M Chocolates.
What is?
FOM is
owned. Oh, it's owned by M&M's?
Yes.
Well, it's nothing like an M&M.
Okay.
Okay, thanks for the good news.
Okay,
FOM, we're back on that from yesterday again. Here's a fax from Bob who says, I graduated from high school in 1952, and we used to have a moment of prayer. Just like today, none of us kids in the class paid any attention to the prayers. We would use that time to pass notes, look around, probably throw a few spitballs, talk to each other, and generally not to pay attention. So I'm sorry to say to the simpleton who wrote to the Sentinel, it won't make a damn bit of difference whether or not you have prayer in a classroom. Religion is no longer relevant, et cetera, and so on. All these people with her, oh, yeah, if you just pray a lot, if you just do this and do that and put up the Ten Commandments. Oh, Jesus, that mentality. Oh, look at this. Here's a bulletin from Clear Channel. I bet you didn't know this. Peter Bolger now has a glory hole in his office door for easy access to corporate sucking. Oh, yeah. Excellent. Must be keeping him busy, too. And by the way, your station, they all suck, Pete. The planet sucks. INZ sucks, except for Rick and Suds. IOD really sucks. And whatever else you got, Love 94, they all suck. And guess what, Pete? You suck, too. Here's Davey. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Okay.
I'm 15, but I've been listening for about 10 years, believe it or not.
Yeah.
Ever since you were at IOD. And I really love your show. I listen to it in world history class every day. It really passes the time.
There you go.
And
sure, an improvement over the crap they're teaching there. I'm positive of that.
Oh, big time. Yeah, I just wanted to ask you a question. Why do you hate Jethro Dull?
Well, it's a matter of taste. I mean, why do I hate vanilla ice cream? It's tasteless, like Jethro Tull.
Oh, yeah, you just don't like their style of music?
I hate it.
Okay, well, can I get a shameless request
yes,
for the
sir?
Old kike lady?
Okay.
Okay, in Big Ken, you're an effing douchebag.
Okay. Oh, God, did he say the old kike lady?
No, Bob Green, I want to tell you something. You're all a bunch of son of a bitches. I just heard what you said.
What did I say?
You want to get rid of this old kike on the phone. You're going to pretend
Who the fuck are you?
Well,
excuse your language now. That's fair.
Excuse your language.
Okay. I always liked that Bob Green. You know, what a sense of humor when he was doing the Phil Henry voice. It's 10:56 at 560 WQM. We've got 400 open lines here today. We're asking for people to call in and pray for us, for each other, for anybody. Pray for the kids out there. Save them from all these insane, crazy people. Most of them religious nuts, by the way. Like that minister who got, well, we don't want to go into that again. 567-0560, pound 560 on the mobile one line. If you're...
WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale. Well, I worked in the rear, and I've got no fear. Won't be go where no man's gone before me. Yeah. If I go to lift, and the room that's left, and the choir taste that leaves you empty, the easily disgusted thing that is heinous. But like a safe man, I'm circling Uranus.
Rectum.
It tastes like a panic to me. The sweetest thing that I've seen. Your moon is shining on me. Tastes like a penny to me. Well, it's safe and be brave. The tongue lashing I just gave makes the hair on my neck stand straight up. Now I'm a real trooper, got my tongue up in your pooper. He's out enough to fill a Dixie cup. I got a mustache made of feces. My friends call me number two. I heard you yelling caca, but I prefer doo-doo. It tastes like a penny to me. The sweetest painter I see. Your moon is shining on me. Tastes like a penny to me. Now put away that KY, cause darling, I'm going and try. Trust me, I won't hurt you. Things get nice and loose when I derail your caboose to you. And I wash it all down with a nice cold brew. Doing what I do leaves me feeling like a man. You'll find it hard to sit down when I get done with your can. Tastes like a penny to me. Your mood is shining on me. Tastes like a penny. Tastes like a penny. Tastes like a penny to me.
1103 at 560 WQM. Apologize for that right in the middle of our lunch. That was only the prequel to Ribs from Tony Roma's. This is our main course from Unsubbed. Jesus Christ, you people sure eat a lot of free food there. Yes, we do, and we enjoy it. And we're sharing with everybody else, and they seem to be enjoying it, and they haven't even popped it in their puss yet either. Unsubbed, which is located at 95 Northwest 1st Street in Miami, right across from the Miami-Dade County Courthouse. And they got fantastic subs and all kinds of great sandwiches, and man. And any kind of their sandwiches and subs, you can also have like I am as a salad. As if I'm not eating the bread is going to make a difference with me today. With the 400 pounds of food that you're force-feeding me here this morning. But it sure is very good. Don't give me a look like that. I wanted it, okay? Like JT has said, or JC or CT, I wanted it. We don't have one person in this audience that knows who 98 Degrees is. I mean, I feel really...
Oh, you know, Penis told me the name of the song, and...
And he was wrong. He said, Because of You or something like
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
That's maybe a year ago that was a song, which I never heard of that. This one is called...
It is so hard.
Hard to do something. Yeah. Hard to watch the video without getting really excited if you're a young lady or a fag. Well, I'm telling you, he's like naked in the thing. He's boxing and he's like really a butch and macho and, you know, any excuse to get some of these guys naked. That's what I always say. 567-0560 and pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. If we only had some living and breathing women in this audience who knew this stuff, besides, you know, the 10 or 20 fags we got. Here's Naples. Hello. Naples.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Neil, this is Julio from Mexico in Naples.
See?
I found you by accident roaming around in tomato fields in Immokalee.
Yeah.
And what got me hooked was hearing you talking about Batavia, Canandaigua, Rochester, Geneva.
Yeah.
I spent 7 great years in Ithaca, beautiful Ithaca, New York.
Right.
And came down.
That's where that damn Gary Bettman is from Cornell.
Right.
Piece of crap.
So, but I'm afraid George may be right. There might be only two bona fide Mexicans.
Two Mexicanos?
Listening to you.
Well, Luis Miguel is a big fan. I know that.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
I don't want you to hang up on me, but I really don't like Luis Miguel, actually.
How about Enrique Iglesias?
Less.
You like him less. How about Ricky Martin?
Much less.
Yeah. How about Christian?
Worse.
Yeah.
I'm kind of old fashioned. I left Mexico in the early 80s, so those people are...
How about Pupi Campo?
I don't even know who that is.
Pupi Compost.
You know, about yesterday's show, most of the people got the well-known Mexicans outside of Mexico. The one that they left out was one that only your pseudo-intellectual audience might be familiar with.
Yeah.
A Nobel Prize winner. The only one we have, but it's for literature, Octavio Paz.
Yeah.
So that,
I'll pass on that.
So that would be the...
They forgot that even though, what's his name, Fernando Lamas, even though he's dead and is not from Mexico, he was from Argentina. But in spite of that, if it weren't for him, not only would we never have had Lorenzo Lamas, but we also wouldn't have ever had Billy Crystal.
But Neil, you know, even though you may only have two Mexicans in Florida, if you were broadcasting in Mexico City, you'll be big.
I'd be real big.
Because here, really, you don't have a good representation of the Mexican.
No.
Okay.
Or of anything else.
Right.
Well, listen, my friend, hasta que yermitas.
Bye-bye.
See you in Batavia. Okay, there's a Mexican from Naples, no less. See, you got to go around the state to find what you're really looking for. 567, did anybody call about 98 degrees? No. What is wrong with this audience, man? Your tastes are so limited. Are you ever going to wake up and sniff the daffodils? 567-0560, and like I told you, my worst nightmare is confirmed in watching that hour of MTV last night, which I never watch it because there's never any videos on anyway. New Kids on the Block. Just when we thought we got rid of them, they're coming back as solo acts. Jordan and what's the other one? Jordan and Joey. And neither one of them could sing. If you held a gun to their head, which ain't a bad idea, might scare them off the stage. Couldn't sing their way out of a paper sack for $1 billion. Here's a lady. Hello, lady in North Miami. What happened to her? Well, that was nice. Well, what was that all about?
I guess she chickened out.
What a bitch. Here's a lady in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
I have the name of the song you're looking for.
Okay.
The hardest thing I'll ever have to do. It is so hard.
Exactly.
That's it.
Now, have you seen 98 Degrees?
I've seen them. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen the video. I've seen them on MTV during a special they had.
Yeah.
Not bad.
Yeah, the lead singer. The rest of them, well, there's only four of them.
Well, two of them are brothers, and the ones with the big noses, they're brothers.
Yeah, but the lead singer, boy, he could he could sure fight in my club. Okay, thanks, sweetheart.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
See, finally, it took a little, because we only got five women listening anyway in the first place on this show. Because, first of all, women especially, young guys and women of all ages don't listen to AM radio, do they?
No.
No. I mean, on Zeta, when I was on Zeta, we had not gigantic women audience, but certainly a hell of a lot more than we got on AM. And 18 to 24, number one by a mile. Number one by a mile. Of course, that was back in the good old days when, you know, when we had a show. I don't care what anybody says. If I have to, those were good days, and it was fun with the Bird and Captain Dave and all of that. It was a different era, but that show wasn't better than this show. Now, what do you, I'm not asking your opinion. What do you know about it?
I listen to it.
Yeah.
Neil wakes me up in the morning.
Except we had better jingles, of course.
Neil wakes me up with
that didn't sound as smart on FM.
Drinking my coffee, munching on my donut.
Yeah, okay. Can't go back. I almost got to that part where they started with You Know Who. And you get very emotional about that. How's he doing, by the way? Did we find out?
We haven't found out.
Mm.
But this is a much better show. That has nothing to do with that element either.
Yeah.
It's just leaner and meaner. You just keep getting better. I'm not the only one that says that.
Well, that's true. I actually have gotten a lot better being on this station because I had to. See, on IOD, you get complacent, fat, and lazy. But on this station, you really have to work at it because this is like an obstacle course running through the sports nerds. A very young Florida Gator team. Oh, my God. I mean, we're talking pathetic. We're talking about emotionally crippled. So what about that 98 degrees, huh? What was that? Heavy breather?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I know him. Probably Greg Reed getting on the wrong line. You know, Pearle Vision is the place to go for all your eye care.
One night only in Boca Raton. Centrum Silver and Shady Hills Retirement Condo Association proudly present the one group taking senior citizens by storm. The Old Spice Girl.
So, you know what I want, but I really, really want?
Yeah.
I forget.
Meet all your favorite Old Spice Girls and get to spend some time with them.
And what? Old Spice Power!
My feet hurt.
Want to see pictures of my grandkids?
I gotta take a nap.
The Old Spice Girls.
If you want to be my lover, you have to change my defense.
More fun than a Matlock Marathon.
It's 11:15 at 560 WQM. See, if you want the answers to these, all of these things, you have to count on the fags out there. Here's a great fax from our friends at Club Cathode Ray, from Paul. He says, I love 98 Degrees. We play that video here all the time, and it's great. Speaking of that lead singer, he says, it's almost time for lunch, and my mouth is wide open.
Oh!
Attaboy, Paul. Open wide, sweetheart. Your mouth, that is. 98 Degrees, man, I'm telling you. See, there are a lot of young guys and young girls who are like in these groups who look good, but that doesn't mean they can sing, you know? Like that group Five, they're British, they're okay as far as the way, they can't sing. And in sync, they stink. No matter what they look like, they just, so on the one hand, although I will confess, see, an ordinary mortal, a less honest person than yours truly, I don't have to come on here and admit this. Because for the last year and a half that I've been fighting you about the Backstreet Boys, I get all these calls from these people who must be writing books out there, who are keeping notes. Well, why do you like them so much? You like the way they look? You've heard those 4,000 calls we've had on it. And I always thought to myself, no, none of them really look all that good. But I watched that new video on MTV last night, which I already had seen in Europe. The new song, I Want It That Way. And I must confess that Nick is starting to look pretty damn good, you know? I mean, it goes to show you, if you put enough makeup, it covers up the zits and even butch them up a little bit. Maybe it's because he's from Tampa. We all know how much I like Tampa. Maybe that's what it is. Nick Carter, you know? And it made me feel like the day that we had Kevin and AJ on a show that time, a little over a year ago, and the rest of the guys were over at Power 96. God damn it! No wonder I hate Kid Curry. Here's Hollywood. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it hard for you to...
567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Neil, long-time listener, first-time caller.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'm here in the port of Miami, and I'm here with my boss. He's a homosexual.
Uh-huh, great. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line.
So...
What?
Woody Graber called.
Yeah.
98 Degrees is going to...
Don't tell me they're going to be at the up there in that outdoor palace.
And do you want tickets?
When is this going to be?
July 10th. He can get you really good tickets.
I won't be here July 10th. I won't be here. I will not be in the country. Ask him when the Backstreet Boys are going to be on June 5th at Amsterdam at that big arena they got, at the Ajax Arena or whatever they call it. Ask him if he can get me tickets to that. That's on a Saturday. See, leave it to Woody Graber. They're going to be here on the... poor Woody, you know, we just can't make contact with him. First of all, I wouldn't care 98 degrees if they were going to be sitting in my lap, even the lead singer, on July the 10th, because to go up to that place and probably would rain like crazy on that day and get pneumonia, it just ain't worth it, is it?
No.
567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. We got 200 open lines here on the board, as usual. We got the mouth breathers calling in. Here's a lady in Carroll City. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hi. I am 68 years old,
yes.
And I wanted you to know that I am a regular listener of yours. So, Does that count for anything?
No.
Of course it does.
Uh-huh. Well,
no.
Yes, it does.
I just wanted to make a few comments on some things you had to say
earlier. Go right ahead. Go right ahead. You'd be the first one.
About where God was.
Uh-huh.
I mean, God gives man free will.
Oh.
And then he can determine.
Yeah, but how can he do that when he already knows ahead of time what man's going to do? See, that doesn't make too much sense.
Well, it does to me.
Oh.
But anyway, and I'm also a gambler, but I have abandoned Vegas. I now go to Mississippi.
Really?
Oh, yes. It's much better.
Hmm.
We've been to Tunica.
It's better than Vegas?
Well, the gambling. I mean, I go to gamble.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel for the gambling, I do better in Mississippi than I do in Vegas.
What do you play?
Blackjack, and they have a new game out now called 3-Card Poker. Fabulous. And then I play the slots.
Mm-hmm.
And I hit on everything. I always come back a winner. I've been to Tunica, to Gulfport, and to Biloxi.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, for a gambler, I don't think there's anything better.
Huh.
Yep.
This weekend sounds pretty good.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
Okay, thanks, sweetheart.
You're welcome.
I'll check it out. Okay, let's get a lot more calls about Biloxi, Mississippi. This lady says it's better than Vegas.
Oh!
How do you like that? Anybody agree with that?
No.
Come on, she says it's better. They're pumping it. They're pushing it. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Lake Worth. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Neil, it's Don from Lake Worth.
Yes,
you were talking about. You were talking about a book about a month ago that you were reading that was helping you with your diet. My mother-in-law's been on a diet, and she hasn't been losing any weight, and I told her about the book you were reading, and I didn't get the name of it. Could you just tell me the name of that book?
Which book is that?
It was the last one that you were reading that, I don't even know the name of it. You were saying that the diuretics in it would keep you from losing weight and some other medications.
Oh, that wasn't a diet book. That was, that was about vitamin B and about homocysteine, and I haven't even got any idea what the name of that book was.
Not the heart solution.
Yeah, the heart solution, right. Well, who's the author of that? You got it written down?
Kilmer McCulley.
Kilmer McCulley. McCulley?
McCulley, as in Calkin?
Yeah, well, something like that, yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.
It's a hardcover. Okay, John. Okay, two lines left on the board. I guess I can finish lunch and go home, huh? Let's put another Marlins game on. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Right.
Okay, get you a real phone that works and call me back someday, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, one call left, and then we can wrap it up. Here's Miami. Hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay.
So you enjoyed your lunch? Anyway, listen, man. I just been watching. Anyway, I just been watching, like, a new videotape that's come from this business called Audience Studies Incorporated.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be for, like, you know, the upcoming sweeps when they're going to be putting in new programs. I saw this program called Ties That Bind. Let me tell you, it sucks. It sucks so much. I can't even believe I said, let me be a volunteer. And you know how much they're trying to say that I'm going to win? $75. I wasted a whole freaking half hour to watch never mind.
Okay. Let's go to Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How's it so hard for you not to...
Let's go to a mobile in Opa-locka. Hello.
Was that
Don't put that
Kelvin?
Asshole on again, by the way, the one that sounds like he's got 20 pounds of dog crap in his mouth, the one I just hit on. What is it?
Is that the guy before that one, was he Geldy? I mean, it sounded like Geldy to
me. Mm-hmm. Geldy Jr.
Jeez, what's going on, Neil?
Not too much, pal. It's another day, another battle here on the home front.
Oh, what a crap stage. This 6'10", I mean, 560 is crap. Oh, my gosh. Anyways, you're the only thing
what
on
does
this
that mean? What does that mean? It's crap. We're kicking ass here. I would agree with you.
Oh, no, you're doing a good job, but the phone lines, the producers, oh, they're awful. They're awful.
Okay, well, thanks for the good news. And Geldy and them on the morning show on Joe and the Bagel Boys this morning, they're wondering why I hate this town like poison, except for the weather. And a good part of the year, the weather ain't so great either. Just take a look at this. Two calls left on the board, and what we got right now is I wouldn't wish it on Heinrich Himmler and the guy that drove through the nursery school. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Bill.
Yes, sir.
You were talking about Francisco Aruga a little while back.
Mm-hmm.
That guy, you know about that guy?
Do I know what about him?
Aruga.
Do I know what? What is there to know? Of course
I
know.
The guy is paid by Castro, a communist, a spy here in Miami.
How do you know that? Why, because he has a different opinion?
Who has a radio station.
Yeah. No, he doesn't have a radio station. He's got a radio program.
Yeah, yeah. Uh-huh. He's talking in favor of Castro all the time,
uh-huh.
talking about Castro, blah, 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 blah,
well,
blah.
Well, let me ask you, doesn't he have a right to do that?
Well, yeah, but when a guy, you know, he's got a lot of people here hurting by Castro, and he's talking about
I apologize to the audience, okay? I'm blessing myself because I said yesterday we weren't going to talk this crap anymore, and I let this guy get on 45 seconds into it. No more of that crap. We don't care. Don't you understand? We are not interested. We don't give a crap, okay? Give it a rest. Adios, arrivederci, hasta luego, hasta que your old meatus, go away. The only reason I even mentioned it is because we got that bit there about Francisco Arruca. That's the only reason I mentioned it. Oh, God, it's so tempting to go back to the same old tired stuff, but why waste the effort? 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Coral Springs. Hello.
Hey, Neil, this is Todd.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Neil, I don't get a chance to listen to your show too much because I work. I happen to be out. Just thought I'd bring up that I never hear 560 talk anything about golf. What's wrong with golf? Why don't you guys talk about something exciting?
Sir, let me ask you, is this a sports show, first of all?
Well, you talk sports sometimes.
No.
You talk about the worst team sometimes.
Yeah.
They never talk about golf.
Okay, why should they?
Well, it's a great game.
It's a sports show. It's a game. It's not a sport. It's not great either. It's boring.
Do you play?
No.
Well, that's too bad. We'd love to have you come to the course where I play, but,
For what?
You still there?
I'm here. Well, what do you want me to come there for? I'm not interested. I don't play golf. It's boring. It's terminal.
Well, I think there's a lot of people that play that disagree with that.
You know something? There's a lot of people love vanilla ice cream, too, so have a nice day. Jesus Christ. In other words, because there's a lot of people that are playing it who have no life and are just killing a lot of time and going out as an excuse to have a few beers and schmooze and waste a few hours? Boring. Boring, sir. Boring! Am I getting the message across, you think?
Uh-huh.
567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line as we continue searching desperately. I mean, we're probing this week. Probing. I'm telling you, we're going to put on the tape of yesterday's Marlin game if you people don't get with it. I think it was Jim Berry, that asshole on Channel 4 Sports last night, even though the game wasn't televised. They had a camera crew out there. In the middle of the game, they like panned around that stadium. They didn't have 13,000 people there yesterday. They had 13. Not 1,300, just 13. I have never seen anything like it in my life, and we're carrying those games on this station. Anybody want to buy any spots?
No.
If you want great Chinese food, if you want great food all the way around, then head for the Emerald Coast. And
Floridians, dumb as dirt.
Okay, this ain't going to queue up in time, but I sure gave it my best shot.
Judge Judy, you know she's tough.
Hey, if I want any more lip out of you, mister, I'll scrape it off my gavel when I smack you in the mouth.
You know she's homespun.
Look, don't pee on my leg and tell me it's raining.
But now, Judge Judy is taking it to the limit in an all-new primetime special.
Death Row, Judge.
Tonight on Fox, the Attorney General of the great state of Texas is allowing death row inmates to have their final appeals heard on TV before...
Death Row, Judge Judy!
Guilty as charged. Do I look like a discount fertilizer dealer to you? You must be crazy if you think I'm going to buy that load of crap. I sentence you to death by the electric chair you're sitting in now. Any last words before I light you up on national TV?
Can I get a cigarette anyway?
No, you'll be smoking soon enough. Trust me, throw the switch!
That's justice. Death Row Judge Judy style. Tonight on Fox.
What a surprise that it's all fake, huh? It's 11:32 at 560 WQM. Just remember this, whatever you see on television, 99 2/3% of it, it's fake, including those wonderful infomercials. Except, of course, for my good close friend Ron Popeil. 567-05. And by the way, I'll tell you the definition of chutzpah, okay? And I know we got some people on the station who are professional apologists for John Henry because he buys them lunch.
Boy, does he have a lot of chutzpah.
Oh, yeah. He says that we have to go where we get the most money. In other words, whichever municipality, whichever city, whichever county provides most public funding, that's where we'll go for our new baseball stadium for the Marlins. Can you believe this? just like I predicted. They just plow right ahead. They don't give a crap if you people out there want to spend one dime of public money for it to build a new stadium for a team that nobody cares about, that nobody is going to, that's been decimated, that's lost 8 million games, that nobody is showing up already now. Oh, well, if we just had the stadium, then we can afford the good players. I read this in the paper this morning. I just wanted to uptuck all over the goddamn floor. Alan Machschnell has written this in the Sun Sentinel this morning. Oh, yeah, but we have to go where the money is, Henry says. He says the Marlins need a new facility because they can't generate enough revenue to field a competitive team at PP Park. So if you just build us a nice big stadium, like downtown there, so that Mickey Arison can have some company and the folks over at the Miami Herald, I think Geldy was right. I think they will build it, no matter what anybody says. They'll just plow it right through. They'll ram it right through, whether anybody wants it or not. Here's Aventura. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How you doing?
Okay, sir.
Right about now, I know you're wishing you were still on vacation, huh? You know, these people... Hello, you there?
I'm listening, sir. I'm here.
Everybody thinks that a new stadium is gonna help the Marlins. The trust has been broken so badly with the fans in South Florida that a new stadium's not going to do it. It's going to take a lot more than that.
Well, not only that, if they started building a new stadium tomorrow, which they won't, but if they did, that's going to take a couple of years. And in the meantime, they're still going to have the rest of this season and two more years of this crap, losing 120, 130 games a year. Who the hell is going to have any interest after that? Who cares?
Move it to Canada, man.
Right.
I think it's dead down here.
Even they don't want it. Move it to Moose Jaw.
Apart from that, that lady who called in about Mississippi,
yeah.
You know, Mississippi is not even a third-rate Vegas. It doesn't even come close. Feels like you're in poor man's Vegas.
Yeah.
No magic to that place. And in Amsterdam, have you ever gone to a bar called the Bulldog?
I know where it is. I've never been there.
It's a cool place.
Yeah.
Neil, you got to go in and smoke a doobie next time you go by.
Okay.
Take care.
See ya. Yeah, can't you see me going into the Bulldog and smoking a doobie in Amsterdam? They don't get it. You think they get it?
Yeah, man.
567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. I'm not interested in smoking some nasty smell and foul weed, okay? One of the most disgusting things I can think of are people sitting around smoking marijuana. Anybody believe that?
No.
No. That sounded good. Like I told you, there's that girl smoking weed waiting for the train at the Central Station in Amsterdam the day we were going to Cologne. Nobody's even paying any attention to her. And why should they? What difference does it make? Was she, like, hallucinating? Was she, like, jumping in front of the train?
No.
Was she, like, driving into a place killing little kids in a nursery somewhere?
No.
Like the American effing way?
No.
No. But if we could have just said a prayer for those poor little kids that got killed in the nursery by that lunatic in his goddamn Jew canoe. How is it possible for there to be so many stupid people in this country? How is it possible? There are people praying up a storm. Is God answering?
No.
Is God listening?
No.
And then these survivors in Oklahoma who were lucky enough not to get killed by the tornadoes. Oh, well, you know, God said, hold out your hand, and I could feel him holding my hand, and he pulled me through. Of course, while he was holding her hand, the other 45 or 50 or 100 people had to find, since now they're finding body parts, and there's a lot more dead people than they thought. But those people, he can only hold so many hands at one time.
Well, how many hands does he have?
That's a good question. He's got the whole world in his hands. That's what Lori London said. Come on, let's sing it. It's National Prayer Day. Come on. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got... Oh, geez. Just dropped half of China. 500 million people just dropped off, and we'll never see them again. What a way to decrease the surplus population, huh? He's got the whole goddamn world. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a lady mobile in Plantation. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, ma'am.
Hi, you really make my day.
Yes, I do.
Listen, I was just wondering, in honor of Mother's Day, you speak so endearingly of your mother. And I
do?
Yeah, and it's just very,
that?
Well, I just find it very charming, and it's cute, too. And I was just wondering if your mother could call you on the air and
no.
We could... No.
No.
The other
no.
thing...
No.
Do you have any brothers and sisters, I was wondering? Because we never hear you talk about them.
Yeah, I have an older brother. Yeah, he's in California.
Oh, okay. So he doesn't listen to you every day?
No. Any day.
So you don't think that your mom, we could hear you guys talk?
No, I don't. I'm not one of those people. I have nothing but contempt for people who talk to their relatives on the air. If you have no show at all, like I don't want to mention Brooke and Randy and some of these other people.
Well, you could just wish her a happy Mother's Day on the air.
Mother's Day is Sunday.
Right.
That's personal.
Well,
this is business, not personal.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Why are you so anxious to hear my mother?
Because I just thought it would be cute to hear her.
No, I don't think so at all. It's not cute. Even off the air, it's not cute.
Then do you think we could do a famous
mother's...
Didn't
you see the planner I put in your room? Could we do what?
Do you want to do a famous mother's list for Mother's Day?
No.
Okay. See ya.
Woo! We've had several mothers call today. Make no mistake about that. Can you believe that? I guess she just doesn't understand the meaning of the word.
No.
It's a simple word, two letters. It's the same in Italiano.
No.
Uh-huh. Espanol.
No.
Inglés.
No.
Whoa. I think I have your mom's number around here.
Sorry. Good. Call her up. The two of you make a match made in heaven. 567-0560, #560 on the AT&T nursing home line. Well, I couldn't resist it. That just keeps coming into my mind, those two words, two little words. 22 before noon at 560 WQM. It's another battle in the big city here, man, as we continue searching for anybody who's got... I mean, even, you know something? Even the lady that called about Biloxi. We had two calls about Biloxi and about Las Vegas. That should have generated 50,000 calls right there. What amazes me the most is not the things that people talk about on these shows in this town over the last 100 years I've been here, but the things that they don't talk about. And then we got some Pudwacker calls up, and isn't it a shame we don't talk more about golf on this station? Jesus Christ, talk about getting a goddamn life. This guy don't know the difference between a nine-hole and a nine-iron and a seven-hole, whatever that is. Seriously, all we can say is
he's an asshole.
21 before noon at QAM.
Five hits, and I'm weak. It mellows me out for the peace I seek. Light that bong, here I go again. I got the munchies, makes me want a snack. And then I'll lie down, gonna take a nap. And then I'll get up, and I'm making tracks. A couple of tokes, and the buzz is coming back. Now I get a thrill when I roll that weed. Talk about my favorite sensibility seed. Make some extra cash and I'll sell you a lid or two. Cause I only roll up on the smoke the best. Boy, I thought I hate to take that urine test. My back porch is worth God only knows where the illegal grass grows.
Something wrong.
Okay, it's 11:45 at 560 WQAM. There's a picture in the paper this morning, and this is in the Sun Sentinel. Sitting room only, showing PP Park yesterday, right in the middle of the Brewers-Marlins game. And there's a smattering of people. Then I notice way in the upper deck down the left field line, that must be where they had all those little kids they let in for like about 50 cents apiece. There are about, somebody said 5,000 of those people up there. So maybe that was like half of the crowd. It had to be more than half. Because there's just a smattering, just a few hundred people around the whole rest of the ballpark. But hey, let's get some public funds together and build John Henry a new stadium, huh?
No.
Come on, let's do it. Two lines on a it's pathetic is what it is. This week is, every time you think you've hit rock bottom here, you come back and you scrape a little bit lower. Just keep scraping it and get a fistful of 567-0560, #560 on the AT&T line. And just when things are going like this, what do we get? We get the nephew walking in here with a sad look on his puss to announce to me they got another QAM van hit today. We can't get anybody on the phone here today, but they're going to go out with a QAM van giving crap away. How do you like that? And wait, have you seen where they're going? Are you familiar with this?
No.
The QAM van will be in Fort Lauderdale today at the Jerk Machine Restaurant.
Stupid, idiotic jerk.
Machine Restaurant. 111 Northwest 2nd Street, just north of Broward Boulevard, between 12:30 and 1:30. Today will be one of your last chances to get free tickets to the second annual New Times International Beer Festival at the War Memorial in Fort Lauderdale tomorrow night. And that's it. That's all it says. Does it have anything else on here that they're giving away?
No.
Like gas?
No.
Like tickets to any ball games?
No.
Like anything?
No.
Like their best wishes?
No.
Free spots on the Marlin games?
No.
Today will be your... I don't know, what's the incentive there for them to come out?
Beer.
Oh, please. Free tickets to the second annual New Times International Beer Festival at the War Memorial in Fort Lauderdale tomorrow night. At the Jerk Machine.
Idiotic jerk.
Oh, God. 5670560, #560. You know what I'm going to do for tomorrow? I'm going to the record store today, this afternoon. Because I'm assuming that the Culligan people aren't showing up today since I never heard from your good friend Todd Dreck, who should only croak a wicked death, by the way, who makes me nauseous. And you're right, I do hate him like poison. And you got the nerve to be talking about Steve Nudelberg, who happens to be a pretty decent guy compared to Todd Dreck. He ain't no Bob.
I love Steve Nudelberg.
He ain't no Bob McKay, but seriously, I mean, you know, these people, bop, 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 and then they never tell you anything. Like, I'm just going to go home and sit around and wait all day and see if somebody shows up. I got important records to buy. We'll have a Ricky Martin concert tomorrow at 98 degrees. And what else, huh? Crease. In your pantaloonies. 5670560. And of course, see, what I don't forgot is that this winter book, that's all gone. That's January, February, and March. This is the 6th of May. This is El 6 de Mayo. And I have to keep, somebody, I think it was Norma I was talking to a couple of days ago. He said, you're forgetting this is May already. This is the beginning of the end until like whenever the people come back, like in December. And he's right. How many times have I told you that? We have the dregs left now. We have nobody here. Here's a mobile in Hollywood. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How are you?
Okay, sir.
Another great show. Long-time listener, first-time caller. I heard some lady calling before about Mississippi gambling.
Mm-hmm.
I've been to Las Vegas probably 24 times over the last 10 years.
Yes.
And my wife and I and another couple made a trip to Gulfport, Mississippi. Stayed at the Grand Hotel and had a heck of a time. The gambling was great. The food was outstanding. No, it's not on the same level as Las Vegas. It doesn't have the glitz. It doesn't have the nightlife. But if you want to gamble and enjoy some good food with Southern hospitality, we really enjoy
it. I don't want no Southern hospitality. I don't want that. That's the last thing that I want.
Well, I got to tell you, the gambling was great. Not just because we won,
yeah,
but because of the way we were treated. The pit bosses, the dealers, you couldn't get friendlier people. And I've been to probably 10 different hotels in Vegas over that period of time, and never had anything as good a time as we did going to Gulfport. Very enjoyable.
You never had as good a time in Vegas as you did in Gulfport, Mississippi?
Strictly on a gambling basis, comparing gambling to gambling.
Yeah.
Yes, socially we've had better times. Obviously we've seen better shows. Obviously we've eaten at better restaurants. But I would say overall, if you want to gamble, it's a great place to go.
Okay.
Enjoy your show, Neil. Keep up the good work, and don't get too disappointed with all the yachtners here.
Okay, see ya.
Take care.
Okay, there you go. There's a big vote for Biloxi, Mississippi. Am I going to go?
No.
No chance. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T wireless line. We're still pressing. We're still pumping. I'm here. Are you there?
No.
Anybody out there today?
No.
Anybody out there this week?
No.
I'm telling you, put the guy down. And they're going out there for another one of these stupid things out there at the what machine?
Idiotic.
Machine. In Fort Lauderdale. 111 Northwest 2nd Street. You know, when are they going to stop this embarrassment? And, you know, and also tomorrow, maybe we'll have the Enrique record in English if we ever see what's his name again that was threatening to bring it in here the other day. I know what his name is. I don't want to give him any publicity. Andrew Cunanan Jr. Here's Miami Beach. Hello. Miami Beach.
Hey, Neil. Listen, I know you can't stand all this Cuban talk, all right? But as long as you're
going. Let's go to Coral Springs. Hello.
Hey, how you doing, Neil?
Okay, sir.
How you been?
Okay.
Hey, I just want to call a couple friends some douchebags.
Yeah, go ahead. We'll give them a call and let us know how they react. 5670560. Listen, I'm not going to give the numbers out anymore. You got no material, okay? You're not fooling me. I had a good time over there in Europe. I come back here to a bunch of deadheads who have no material. So I'm just going to play music and sit around and pout for 2 hours.
You are
pathetic.
My fire, the one. Desire, believe, when I say I want it that way. But we are two worlds apart, can't reach to your heart, fire, the one desire you are.
It's 11:55 at 560 WQM. We got Hank.
WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
There was an old farmer who lived on a rock. He sat in the meadow just shaking his fist at some boys who were down by the creek. Their feet in the water, their hands on their marbles and playthings, and at 4:30, there came a young lady. She looked like a pretty young creature. She sat on the grass. She pulled up her dress, and she showed them her rumples and laces and white fluffy duck. She said she was learning a new way to bring up her children so they would not spit. While the boys in the barnyard were shoveling refuse and litter from yesterday's hunt, while the girl in the meadow was rubbing her eyes at the fellow down by the dock. He looked like a man with a sizable home in the country with a big fence out front. If he asked her politely, she'd show him her little pet dog who was subject to fits. And maybe she'd let him grab hold of her small tender hands with a movement so quick. And then she'd bend over and suck on his candy so tasty made of butterscotch. And then he'd spread whipped cream all over her cookies that she had left out on her shelf. If you think this is dirty, you can go f*** yourself.
Come on, let's talk a little bit of golf talk. Come on, it's 12 noon at 560 WQM. We got a real dense crowd here today, let me tell you, in every aspect of the word. 5670560, pound 560 on the mobile one line. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I'm heading to Italy today, and the first thing I'll do, of course, is buy a Cigar Aficionado magazine in Miami Airport.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm wondering if you have any suggestions, you know, little places, out-of-the-way places that are must-sees. We're going to Rome, Florence, the Cinque Terre, and Venice.
Well, have a great time.
And any place in particular that's a must-see spot or a must-hit restaurant or something?
No.
Nothing.
Just don't go to McDonald's.
Enjoy it all.
Okay, have a great time.
Thank you.
Here's our last call today. Here's a mobile pig report in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes,
there's,
sir.
You got some motorcycle cops there in between McNabb and Atlantic in the median. They got some people pulled over. I don't want anybody else to be next.
Okay, God bless you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, just don't answer anymore. I'll take them, okay? Let's just do it that way the rest of the day. It'll, you know, spice it up a little bit. No, seriously, it's just their mentality. That's just the way they are. Here's a mobile and maybe not. Mobile in West Palm Beach. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes,
sir. I'm getting out of this town tomorrow morning.
Yeah. Going to Italy?
Mississippi. No, I wish.
Oh, Mississippi?
I'm Tunica.
You wearing a tunic and going to Mississippi?
I'm going
probably
to Tunica.
Your ass. Yeah.
No, I'm all VIP comped out at the Horseshoe, so I've been going there for a few years now. I usually have a pretty good time. Ever tried there?
No, I never been to Mississippi. I once drove through there real fast.
I grew up out in Vegas, and I'll tell you, it's the closest the casinos would have managed in the games to Vegas that I've seen.
Better okay, well, listen, have a great time, and I'll take your word for it, okay? I'm not going to Mississippi, okay? I do appreciate it. I'd ask for people to call about that. But if you think that I'm going to go there, the answer is very clearly
no.
No chance. 567-0560, pound 560 on the Mobile One line. QAM.
Hello, Neil?
Yes?
How are you?
Okay.
Listen, I just wondered if I could pass a message on to John Henry.
Yeah.
Hey, John, kiss my ass!
Okay, thank you. You hear that, John? See, we got people kissing his ass, people that work on this station kissing John Henry's ass, for whatever reason, I don't know. But the fact is, maybe you're a nice guy, John Henry, maybe not. I don't know you, I don't want to know you, but forget about that ballpark. Please, do us all a favor and just take the team and go away somewhere. Nobody here cares. There's no interest. There's as much interest in that ballpark as there is in the show today. None. WQAM.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I got a famous Puerto Rican for you.
I'm listening.
Roberto Clemente.
Okay, thank you very much. Roberto Clemente, did we have that yesterday?
Yes!
5,000 times?
Yes!
Huh? Did we have it?
Yes.
What did I tell you? These people, this is the weakest bunch of people. It's unbelievable. How about, let's talk about Fernando Lamas again, okay? He's from Buenos Aires, Argentina, huh? You look marvelous. WQAM. QAM.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I'm going over to Sunrise. Is there any hot points I can hit?
McDonald's there on the corner right near the Shell
station.
Oh,
I know it well, Neil. I know
it
well.
Right on the way to the stadium?
I'm telling you. Listen, I got one thing to probably...
These people just amaze me. Are there like any little out-of-the-way, you know, glory
holes
in the Vatican? I don't know what they're talking about.
You are the guide to the world, Neil.
Uh-huh.
To put this whole spig thing to bed, okay, if you let me...
WQAM.
Hey, George.
Yeah.
Talk to Neil.
Okay, hold on. Where are you calling from?
Boca.
Okay, let's go to Boca. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
They're not going to be interrupting you today for baseball, are they?
Oh, I wish. I pray. I pray we had a game coming up in about 5 minutes the way this is going.
Well, that's how
fast. See, I don't understand this crowd. They get pissed off if we got a ball game, like it's taking their livelihood away if they interrupt the show like yesterday, and then when I'm here for the whole 4 hours, nobody wants to speak to me. I don't get it. I don't understand this crowd. This is the retardo crowed. I don't get this place.
Well, I've never gotten through this fast, Neil.
Yeah, well, you're on now, man. You're
I know.
Right. I'm doing Screenless, and I can't get more than a couple of calls lit up here at the same time. That's the kind of audience we got here now, and it's May, June, July, August, September, October, November. We got another 6 months like this. The party's over, baby. Everybody with a brain, they already got out of this town while the getting was good, and now we're stuck here. 567-0560, and then this morning they're talking about, oh, well, there's nothing to do in New York. New York's a toilet. There's nothing to do there. Right. I can't think of a more boring place than New York, can you? Boy, what a bunch of suckholes there. Because you got a basketball rivalry going on, so let's talk about what a boring place New York is. Jesus Christ, Defoe. Man, that guy was right that called this morning, called him a suckhole. QAM.
Hello?
WQAM, yes, sir.
Hi, I'd like to talk to Neil.
Where are you calling from?
I'm in Pembroke Pines right now.
Okay, let's go to Pembroke Pines. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I got selected by the good people over at Arbitron. It starts today, runs through this week.
God bless you, sir. Always liked you a lot.
You know, I was surprised when they called me on the phone if I would be a part of it. They said that they would pay me for it.
Right.
You know how much they pay you?
$2.
$1.
Oh, now it's $1? Oh, that's right. You're white. Put on some blackface. I think they pay you $5.
Well, I'm going to put you down, and I hope you get a nice big fat bonus next rating.
God bless you, sir.
All right.
I'll say a prayer for you.
Thank you.
Thank you. See, we always like the people in the diaries. We never tell them anything about, you know, so do this because you can't do that. Because they get real uptight up there in Beltsville, Maryland, all those goyim up there. So we never tell you what. Oh, now all of a sudden they finally caught on. You know, this is so slow here. It must be the heat. It's got to be the heat. I'm not talking about the basketball team. And please don't try to rationalize for me a bunch of white people going to watch a bunch of 7 foot tall black guys jamming each other with the elbows and jamming a ball in a basket. I'm sorry. I don't buy that. You're not fooling me. WQAM, hello.
You son of a bitch.
Okay, thanks. WQAM, hello.
Yeah, Neil.
Yes.
I'm Q1, and I don't know what to do with myself, man.
Well, how about go play with yourself for a start? Probably got plenty of practice. WQAM.
Hello.
Yes,
it sounds
sir.
Like Neil.
It is.
Hey, Neil.
Screenless Thursday, sir. I know this audience, they haven't caught on yet. Screenless Thursday from here till 2 o'clock.
That's great. Hey, did you ever get I sent you a couple pictures. It was a billboard. This was a while back. A billboard. It said, you know, the one of the famous Sun Coast gun shows or whatever, on a billboard, and on the back it had that, I don't know if you ever saw a billboard, it said, "Not one more dead child."
No.
It was against guns.
Mm-hmm.
But on the very back side of this billboard was that Sun Coast or Gold Coast show that they all advertised.
Yeah.
Can you believe that? I mean,
of
you
course.
Want to talk to-
I'm just wondering when it's going to be before we have the gun show spots starting on this station and on this show again.
Neil, it kills me that you don't have say-so on what spots are on there.
No, you don't. Nobody's got that. Nobody's got any control over Rob.
I wish you had that. But, Neil, the other day, my
wife... All I can do is spice those spots up a little bit, you know.
I know you're not big on Whoopi Goldberg, but my wife loves her, and she always watches that, the Hollywood Square show. They had a survey. 66% of the priests surveyed could not recite the Ten Commandments, Neil.
Yeah.
I mean, that's in a nutshell. Here they are trying to preach all this crap. They don't even know what they're preaching. I mean, it's absurd.
Thou shalt not molest altar boys, is that?
There's no flags in the church.
Yeah.
Yeah, that should be the first one on the list, that's for sure.
Okay, God bless you, sir. It's prayer day. Go put your hands together.
Oh, hallelujah, man.
And say a good prayer, okay. We still have got no calls about that. It's prayer day, God damn it. What's wrong with you heathen bastards out there? We're supposed to be praying today. Save the children from all this slaughter from these crazy people. Save the senior citizens. Save all the rest of us. Save everybody from crazy people like Charlton Heston. What is the story on this line? Hello?
Yeah, Neil?
Yes, sir.
Dead or alive, Florida Marlins.
Okay, I'm glad I was just doing a line check there, and thank you very much. He cooperated. That was good. The answer, sir, is dead as a doornail. Hey, guess what, John Henry? We don't want your goddamn new stadium, okay? I mean, talk about arrogance. He just announces it. It's not a question of if. It's just a question of where. That's kind of a new twist on that old deal. Where you're going to build it for me? We got something that you can have for free.
Rectum.
Jackass. Hey, you're looking for fast, easy, reliable access to the internet without...
What's this obsession with Hokey?
On the next, where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? The kids track down the elusive Sandiego to a harem in Saudi Arabia, where she has been selling teenage girls to a sultan as sex slaves. Play along as they follow the erotic clues to Carmen's whereabouts. We may be public broadcasting, but we know sweeps when we see it.
Call 14 at 560.
Carmen Sandiego.
WQAM. You know what I want now? Banana split. What? Doesn't that sound good? I don't give a crap about Atkins or Skatkins or any of that right now. First of all, we both ate way too much in the first place. I mean, some nerve of that Jeff High to bring us in ribs from Tony Roma's when we had another lunch coming already, like we needed a prequel to lunch. We're not all fat slobs like he is. But a banana split sounds really good. We don't have any place around here like that, you know? That's what we need is like an old soda fountain. Oh, God. What drug chain used to have those? Not Walgreens.
Was it Rexall?
Was it? You used to have like a real soda fountain where you could get like, where they had a soda jerk. You know what I'm talking about?
Idiotic.
Yeah, he was in there.
Malted.
Mm.
With whipped cream.
Right, like a real authentic malted. Oh, God.
Heavy on the malt.
I feel like a malted. I know, you look like marvelous. Boy, that sounds good. I know it's bad for you. Get your blood sugar soaring up there and all those homocysteines, that homo problem you got. I don't care. That's this audience does it to you. I realize now, you know, I went on vacation for 9 days. I came back. I weighed exactly the same. I'm not saying I didn't eat a little bit of crap while I was away, but nothing, you know, not too much. Nothing real bad. Weighed exactly the same as when I left. That's pretty good for going on vacation, I would say. Especially with that great food on Virgin Atlantic, by the way, on the plane. Did I mention Virgin Atlantic enough times yet?
No.
God, are they great. They really are. But right now, that sounds so goddamn good. There used to be a drugstore over on Alton Road when I lived on the beach very briefly in 1976. There was a drugstore. I told you the story the day that my credit card wouldn't work in the thing at Flagship Bank. Remember Flagship Bank? And I went to the bank to take a few bucks out, and for whatever reason, the thing was out of order, and I couldn't get any cash. I had no cash on a Sunday. And I was going to go hungry. I felt like some kind of like a hunderling. And I'm crossing Alton Road to go back to my little apartment where the Spanish Jews were, who used to make all that noise and drove me out. And I look down by the curb, and there's eight $1 bills all like rolled up. Somebody had dropped $8. And I went into that. It was like a pharmacy, but they had a soda fountain in the front. I'm sure it's long gone. God, was that good. And for dessert, I had a nice big banana split. Mmm. WQAM. WQAM.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay, sir.
You're picking up the phones today, huh?
I am now.
Listen, Neil, I just want to let you know. George
said he wouldn't touch this show with somebody else's hand.
I wanted to tell you about a great movie. I'm kind of a movie buff. And,
okay.
I saw a great movie yesterday. The guy was nominated for an Oscar, but it's one of those movies that, you know, they didn't spend a lot of money. And, you know, they don't get, like, Titanic, all the exposure. It's called American History X.
Yeah.
You got to check out that flick. It's a very good movie. You know, speaking of all these skinheads and all this problem in Colorado,
mm-hmm.
It's a very good insight, and that should be required reading for teenagers nowadays, to tell you the truth. So check it out, okay?
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Okay. What did he say?
Yeah.
He said, what is it called, American Graffiti? That was a bad movie. That was really bad. Although they did, it was at a soda fountain. They had a soda jerk. They had a
idiotic jerk
who used to bring the stuff out to the curbside. Like they do with Steak and Shake. I wonder when the Steak and Shake opens very soon, by the way. I think it's next month, the one out there by the Sawgrass. I wonder if they're going to have curb service like they do in Tampa and Orlando at Steak and Shake. Now, there is a place you can get a good chocolate malted. Mmm. God. See, and if there was a God, all the stuff that tastes so great, it wouldn't be bad for you. It wouldn't kill us. That right there, the proof should be in your pudding, okay, in your goddamn boring vanilla tapioca pudding. There's the proof right there that there's no God. Either when it's going in or when it's coming out. Oh, God. WQAM.
Hey, can I talk to Neil?
Speaking.
Neil, you are my God. How do you think Fright Couples is going to do in the Tucson Open next week?
Yeah, how about those couples at the couple swingers places, huh? Will you get any calls about that, by the way?
No.
About that thing on Channel 10? Probably our audience don't watch Channel 10 news any more than we do. About that piece they did two nights ago? About that fascist Ken Jenny in Broward County? And the cops raiding the swingers clubs. WQAM.
Hello, Mr. Neil, please.
Speaking.
Neil, that was Woolworth used to have those nice photos.
Right, that's right. Woolworth used to have a nice fountain in the front.
Yes, sir. Have a good day, sir.
Thank you. Woolworths. That's where we got most of our equipment here at QAM, by the way. No hot fudge sundae or banana splits, but we sure got some good old crappy stuff. There you go. Hey, two of the three decks work on our cart machine. Deck rhymes with dreck. How's Todd doing, by the way? Did he tell us yet when they're coming to...
No.
You're right. He's a piece of crap. You're right about that. George says you're a piece of crap, Todd. No, seriously. I'm seconding... In fact, I think I said it first. And George said, yeah, you're right. I mean, we got some salespeople that are okay, like John Penis and Brian and anybody else. That's it. Well, the rest of the salespeople who are good guys, they have nothing to do with our show. They're all sports holes. We got 50,000 salespeople selling the Marlins, by the way, and the Dolphins and the Panthers. Any interest?
No.
No. Dolphins and the Panthers seasons are a long way away, and the only thing we got going now is the Marlins. And is anybody...
No.
See, I can't even finish the question. And they're already saying...
No.
No. Before I even get to... You want to buy some...
No.
No. Because they know what we're getting at. They know that the rest of the day is all sold out. We got a waiting list to get spots on this station. See, I don't get what kind of a deal he must have made, because the games... We're still continuing with these Marlins games and that lawsuit. We never heard another word about any of that. But you know that no matter what kind of a deal they made, we're still losing our ass on that. Because not only is there nobody wants to buy any spots, but nobody even is showing up at the ballpark. That picture in the paper this morning, it's unbelievable. You could have not only your own section, you could have your own baseline. You could have the whole right field line, the left field line. You could have all the whole area behind home plate, behind the screen. WQAM.
Good afternoon, Neil.
Yes, sir. Buenas tardes.
Oh, man, like you, I called in sick for work today, and I said, the hell with the Atkins. When I got myself some Enemann donuts and some wavy gravy.
Wavy gravy's good, yeah.
Oh, I'm going to sit here and just, let my blood sugar level soar to heights unknown.
Don't go far from home if you have that wavy gravy.
Yeah, I'm staying close.
Okay.
Sorry about all this South Florida clientele around here. Tough to get a good show together. I'm trying to turn somebody on to your show. And,
yeah.
Today's the first exposure to your show. So,
well, tell them to expose this.
Yeah.
Feel better, pal.
Anyway, take it easy. I love you.
See ya. Okay. Hey, I don't worry about that, okay? If the guy don't like our show, screw him, okay? If you don't have a sense of humor, like we're doing a show for one guy out there, if you don't have a sense of humor, if you don't understand that we're doing a show in the middle of a goddamn outdoor funeral parlor, then look around you, okay? Smell the death in the air. They thought that was smoke from the Everglades a couple of weeks ago. There was no smoke. There were no fires. It was the death in the air, the stench of decaying, rotting bodies, old fossils, prehistoric cretins. And that's how I'm expected to do a show talking to those people every day.
Oh, you ought to go to Biloxi. It's 1,000 times better than Vegas.
Yeah, right. You first, okay? Go to Mississippi with a banjo on my knee, or is that to Alabama? That's where we sent Pavel Bure, by the way, to a banjo with a banjo on his knee. And that's what the doctor over there said. He said, that's the problem. Get the goddamn banjo off. He'll be able to skate better. Isn't that what he said, Dr. Andrews, whichever guy it was? Oh, geez. And then at Cleveland Clinic, let's get talking about them again, okay? I'm starting to get bitter now. I better get that hot fudge sundae real quick. Oh, that sounds good. Hot fudge sundae on Rocky Road. Oh, you know where I think I'm going to stop on the way home? You know they have that Baskin-Robbins drive-thru at 163rd? You know what I'm talking about? Right off the interchange there by the Golden Glades, you just go east on 163rd about 10 blocks or less, and there's a Baskin-Robbins with a drive-thru. There's nothing. You get past the toll plaza, and then you can use both hands. No, you're steering with your elbows, you know. Oh, and I never told a story about what happened on Monday. I told you. I'm driving home up the turnpike on Monday. And the traffic, I'm getting right to 595, and the traffic in front of me is acting like a little spastic, like they're speeding up and slowing down, the typical South Florida effing way. And I'm thinking about zooming by them, but we're getting pretty close to the intersection of 595 and the turnpike. I thought, okay, I'm going to lay back a little here. You know, once in a while, even when you got a nice fast car, you lay back a little bit. And sure enough, I see a brown car, maybe about a quarter of a mile up, coming horizontally, not in an angle, horizontally straight across the road. And I slam on the brake, thank God, and the cars in front of me did the same. And this crazy bitch, she just goes right across and smacks into the goddamn median rail there. And I look in the rearview mirror as I got by, and she's sitting there dazed, and somebody else got out of the car. I would have stopped, but there was somebody else in there, and they got out. Nobody got hurt bad, but the front end of the car just smashed. She made a quick right. A hard right. Straight across the frickin' road, across two lanes of traffic, into the goddamn median. Nice going, lady, you crazy old bitch. WQAM.
Marty Cone.
WQAM.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
Remember Cunningham's? That was always a good...
Yeah, in East Lansing, right. You're right.
Yeah. So you're back.
Yeah.
All right. That was all.
Oh, okay.
They were all over Detroit, actually.
Well, I mean, the one I knew was in East Lansing where I was going to school, but thank you so much on Grand River Avenue. So you're back. That's you know, it's funny he should say that because I was thinking the same thing. So I'm back. Christ. You know something? It's appropriate that it's prayer day because when I leave here, I'm going to say a prayer that I don't have to ever come back in. Maybe instead of $8 in the street, I'll find $8 million in the street when I leave here today in small bills. In fact, I'm going to pray right now. Baruch atah Adonai, 8 million sounds good to me, but I pray pre-hagofen, okay? I'll see you. Have a great life. I'll see you in Biloxi. Not. Yeah, that's about the average speed of the people in this town, Biloxi, Mississippi. That sounds about right. That sounds like where a lot of you would have a real good time. You'd fit in like a goddamn proctologist glove in somebody's...
Rectum.
WQAM.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, Neil?
Great. Never been better, sir.
Good.
The audience is under the weather, but I'm doing great.
Well, what's going on with the audience?
I'm getting ready. Huh?
What's going on with the audience today?
You tell me. I don't know.
Oh, yeah?
They're under the weather.
I just wanted to say, I was reading CityLink today.
Yeah.
And I was looking under the singles thing, 109, section 109.
The singles thing?
The singles section.
And?
And there was some dateline in there. It's called the Swinging Singles Dateline.
Yeah.
It is one crazy line, I'll tell you. I just thought I'd tell you about that.
Okay, well, call up Sheriff Ken Jenny, and I'm sure he'll put him out of business in no time. They'll all be in jail before midnight. Any spy reports on that Channel 10 piece 2 nights ago?
No.
On a swinging club?
No.
On a Broward County fascist?
No.
No. Just checking. I don't want to get nosy. By the way, I'm going to be talking to my mother in a few minutes about Mother's Day. Am I going to be doing that?
No.
That woman, she was the best. She was ridiculous.
How about having your mother? I mean, people that call their mothers on the air...
And their other relatives.
Well,
desperate would be a compliment. You know what I'm saying, Randy? With that jappy routine of hers. By the way, nice numbers on the afternoon there on INZ. Woo! Heavy duty. You know, it's interesting. Look at the tremendous field of talent they brought in, you know? There was Greg and Mike Church and John Ford. Scoop the Poop. Karen Kay. A whole And then, of course, this one who left and came back again.
He forgot Ski.
And Ski, and yeah. And then what was the other guy? What the hell was the, oh, the Sheik. Now, was that hit? That was a Steve Nichols thing, wasn't
yeah.
it?
Come on, Neil, you can do better than that.
Oh, wait, you know, I never heard that at the end. Listen.
Come on, Neil, you can do better than that.
Well, his last is the best. His last is good as Brooks.
Oh, my God. That's beautiful. 26 past noon at 560 WQAM. Loretta.
Sports Talk Radio, 560 WQAM. Is proud to present 4 hours of excitement, action, and fun. 6 to 10 a.m. Monday through Friday. We're proud to present the Eliana Rosanna Dana Ross Lateman Show, along with her funny, zany sidekicks, Jersey Jetzel and Claude Pepper. 6 to 10 a.m. only on 560 WQAM.
I always like that Jersey Jetzel. It's 1232. In fact, they named a car after him. 1232 at 560 WQAM. We're doing Screenless today. It's not helping too much. But we're doing the best we can. Now, that Peter Leonard, that ass from our sales department, just stuck his head in the door a couple of minutes ago. And what did he say to you? I want to recount this conversation right on the air.
Tell Neil he's smoking, man. He's awesome. He's been great, man. He's just been on fire the past 2 days.
And you told me that he said that. And what did I say to you?
What an asshole. What a piece of...
crap.
Well, you didn't say crap.
I said with an S-H. I mean, well, what is the purpose of that? Go out and sell something, Peter, okay? I don't need you to validate my existence. I got these numbers here in front of me. You know what I can do with these numbers? I can, like that lady said that time, stick them up his ass, then he'll always have them. I could wipe my ass with these numbers for all the good it does being on here in this town. I have ratings that are so astronomical here that it's almost criminal. It's almost a sin. It's almost unheard of to have numbers like these on a goddamn make-believe radio station like this on AM with no promotion and a general manager with a really bad haircut and a brain to match. And in spite of that, like I said, I could wipe my fat
rectum
with it and for all the good it does. It's meaningless. And it's never been any different. I don't know why, just you can't accept it. It's never been any different. 23 years of a battle. It's always been a goddamn battle. It's not rocket scientist. Call up and say something, that's all. The worst that can happen is we can make you look like some kind of a jackass, which probably you don't need a lot of help. And I'm doing Screenless now, and look at that. They're dropping off as I'm speaking because it only rings 100 times. And I'm killing a lot of time now, hoping they'll all drop off. Or just drop. WQAM. See what I'm saying? WQAM.
Hey, I got a famous Mexican for you, Neil.
WQAM.
Oh, man, you gotta come to Neil.
WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
I'm trying to figure out, have you understood that hockey's nothing but soccer?
WQAM.
Hey, faggot.
Yeah.
Hey, how does the penis taste?
WQAM.
Yeah, this is Don, Neil. I live out of town, but I'm down here on business. First of all, I don't know where you get all these yentas calling you. They're ridiculous. Your favorite sport, may I talk about it for a minute?
You can talk about whatever you like, sir.
Well, if I remember correctly. Like
last guy wanted to talk about penis. You want to talk about hockey. Go ahead.
I live in St. Louis, but I know Toronto's your favorite team.
Yeah.
It looks like Toronto may have a good run here. Joseph gets hot, you guys could go maybe a long way.
Yeah.
What do you think?
They got home advantage the rest of the conference playoffs.
Wow, they may be the real sleeper in this whole thing.
Could be.
Yeah.
Could be. The offense hasn't even exploded yet. It's going to explode in the Pittsburgh series because they're not playing a clutch-and-grab coma team like Philadelphia.
Yeah, I agree with you. But I think that Pittsburgh played over their head and got through that round, and I think that...
But what do you mean they played over their head? I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't think Pittsburgh's up this year, and I think they played a little bit better than what they should have played with.
Or maybe New Jersey played under their head and choked like choking dogs, which they're famous for doing the last 3 years, and they did it again is more likely.
The Lamalella, whatever the general manager's name, ought to do more than choke you, ought to die, if you know the relationship with St. Louis.
Yeah.
We got through. Did you see that game the other night, by the way?
Yeah, I saw it. I didn't stay up to see the end. I saw the replay. I saw the deflected goal, yeah.
Yeah, 2 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, now, that's the way playoff hockey should be played.
No, it shouldn't. Who the hell wants to see a scoreless tie going to 2 minutes left in the first overtime?
Yeah. Neil, like
I want to see a 6-5 game. I don't want to see 1-0, sir.
Yeah. Hey, I'm from out of town. I listen to you when I'm driving around down here. Best of luck. Goodbye.
And God bless you, sir. Okay, good luck to you. You'll need it. Although Dallas had a tough time with Edmonton, so maybe Dallas will be just like Jersey and just choke, bite the big one. Could be. That's coming up tonight right here on QAM 745, Dallas and the St. Louis Blues. And the other game, of course, tonight, Boston and Buffalo. That should be a 1-0 snoozer. Could be. Watch out for that Michael Pecker, by the way. WQAM.
Can I speak to Neil, please?
Speaking.
Neil, hi. I never called you before, but today I don't think I could do any worse than the people you've had on.
Probably not more. Why don't you give it a shot?
You were talking about stadiums. Every day I drive by, actually both Miami Heat stadiums, the old one and the new one. I mean, what a disgrace that they ruin, 2 acres of beachfront property with a stadium when there's one a block away.
Yeah.
And I don't know.
Seems to make all the sense in the world to anybody with a brain that if people don't want to go to the first place because it's in a bad part of town, they're not going to want to go to the new place. But don't confuse anybody with that because we got a corrupt mayor in Dade County. We got a guy with $9 billion that daddy's hiding in Israel somewhere over there, Mickey Arison. And we got a bunch of lemmings here that you can pull the wool over their eyes. And like I said, they'll build a new baseball stadium because there's no passion for or against anything in this town. They just don't give a crap.
Well, just build it, you know, hope he builds it himself and puts it out in the Everglades somewhere.
He's not going to build it himself. He already made that clear. He's like a whore now. He's holding himself up to the highest bidder. Whatever city or county assholes come up with the most public money, that's where they're going to put the stadium. He doesn't give a crap. Like you say, if they put it in the Everglades, he doesn't care. If the Indians out there want to put up the money, he'll play out there and get the same number of people to come, by the way. Nobody.
Every day I drive by this, they're like, what an abortion. What a waste of good space.
Yeah.
Okay, Neil. Thank you, sir. Have a good day.
And like Tiny Tim said, Happy New Year. You know what Tiny Tim said? Something like that?
Uh-huh.
567, what? 0560. Well, we haven't heard about lately, thank God. When that guy from Tampa called, I wanted to give him a medal for not mentioning you know who. 567-0560, #560 on the Mobile One line. We got Hank Goldberg at 2 o'clock. We got Jim Mandich at 6. We got the St. Louis Blues in Dallas. By the way, that guy from, isn't that interesting? The guy from out of town from St. Louis, he had something to say about the hockey playoffs. The rest of the people in this town, I'll give you an example of a brilliant call. This morning I'm driving in, just when I get to the building, some jackass is on there. Oh, I'll tell you one thing. If Brian Murray doesn't make a big offer for Eric Lindros with all the rumors about him leaving Philadelphia. And Geldy, for once in his life, gave the right answer. Sir, you're an asshole. You're impossible.
Idiotic.
Yeah, exactly. Like they can afford $10 million a year for Pavel Bure and $10 million a year for Eric Lindros. How about also Jaromir Jagr? We'll pay him $10 million a year if the Penguins get folded up. There is no interest in that. There's no interest in anything. Like I've told you before, pick the topic. Other than anal sex, there is no interest in this town in anything. That's all they know is anal sex and butt licking, which I see a lot of similarity there. And, of course, the poll question today is, which do you do first? Lick it or stick it? Isn't that what Tom Hopkins always said? I wonder if that's in here under the, is that in here?
Lick it and stick it.
Yeah, it's in there. Nice going, Tom. By the way, speaking of Tom, don't forget Tom Jicha, who hasn't written the word about our great rating book, about the fact that there was a winter rating period in this town and in this market, and is supposed to be the radio and TV writer in the prestigious Sun Sentinel, but hasn't written a word about it yet. But he'll be on there tonight probably talking about dog racing and Hi-Li for Ed Kaplan after the hockey game. Come on, Tom, give us a break, goddammit. For once in your life, give us a break. Give us a little something. Just because I don't hang out at the track with you guys. 21 before 1 at 560 WQM.
That the Lord even loves Neil Rogers.
If you love those great songs from those great mafia movies, you'll flip over Real Mob Hits. Not only does Real Mob Hits give you more of that great mob music, but you also get awesome sounds of Real Mob Hits. Like Luca the Ice Pick Fiamma getting his at the 106th Street Barbershop. Forget about it. Or who can forget Sally the Fish getting the old piano wire across the throat. If I remember correctly, it was a B-flat. So order Real Mob Hits now if you know what's good for you. Just by dialing 1-800-BADA-BING. Real Mob Hits. Hey, it's real. Forget about it.
Israel. 1244 at 560 WQM. By the way, speaking of hockey playoffs, David J. Neal continues to amaze me. You know, I mean, he tried to do a little job here in the Herald this morning with a little roundup of the conference semifinals, his predictions, yada, yada, yada. He picks the Leafs to beat the Penguins in 6. That's nice, but he's got the injuries on all the teams here. Maple Leafs injuries, center Alan McCauley, concussion doubtful. Defenseman Alexander Karpatsev, shoulder strain is questionable. Then he goes on with the Penguins injuries. How about Igor Korolev with a broken foot? Is he going to play?
No.
David Schwoneil?
No.
No. How come he ain't on there? Schmuck. But, of course, he can get away with it here because these people know nothing about any of this stuff. Hey, if they don't get Eric Lindros there and Jaromir Jagr, too, and anybody else we can throw in there,
get a payroll of about $200 million a year? WQAM, hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Great.
I wanted to get your opinion on something. Argentinians, how would you classify them? I mean, here's the people that are Spanish, but then again have the same background of European.
Would I classify them?
What's that?
I would say like
classify them. Just,
10th world people.
Where would you rank them?
Rank them with what? Rank them with what? As in the cross-dressers?
Rank them. I mean,
number one,
like,
cross-dressers.
I'm Argentinian. When I fill out an application,
yeah,
it has white, Spanish, and so forth. I'm white. I mean, my ancestors are as white as I mean, they're from Austria, Italy, and
yeah,
so forth.
Yeah, sure. We believe you.
Right? So what is your opinion on that?
Opinion on what? Are you white?
I'm white.
You're Hispanic,
yeah, definitely.
And you think you're white? Well, if you want to believe that, go ahead.
But, I mean, I think we are white, though.
We believe
white,
you.
And we're not Spanish. I mean, I'm not like no stick Colombian or something like that.
Oh, of course not. We believe you.
So I'm better than them, right?
You're a lot better. They have better drugs, but you're better a dresser. Okay. Oh, God, what is he? There's another guy who wants to compartmentalize himself again. Like I try to tell you, stop worrying about all this ethnic horse crap, will you please? Stop with it already. What am I? Am I this? Am I that? Am I... What is he?
He's an asshole.
Jesus Christ. 567-0560-#560 on the mobile one line. What am I? Like Admiral Stockdale. Who am I? This guy's what am I? How about, you know, about 5'10" full of... How about that? I don't know what you are. Bring it over here and let's see it. 567-0560. We're doing Screenless and I still got a pump to get all these lines lit up to make me feel better about my life. Not that it makes any difference. WQAM.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I'm a mutt, by the way.
And?
I'm just joking with the other guy. I got a quick question for you. I haven't heard it in a while. Did you hear anything about McGuire retiring?
About what?
Mark McGuire retiring.
Paul McGuire retiring?
Yeah.
No.
Someone told me about it, and I didn't believe
it. Well, tell him he's full of crap, okay? Tell him to look in the box score. He ain't retiring, okay? Just another home run the other night, and he's playing every day as if anybody cares. Anybody care about baseball here?
No.
Mark McGuire?
No.
Phyllis McGuire?
No.
Paul McGuire?
No.
The McGuire sisters?
No.
Okay. Wasn't it Phyllis McGuire that got into the thing with a cop out there? She got arrested for a drunk driving or something? This was a few weeks ago. Remember that? Got into a big snit. Rhymes with... And she said, don't give me any. WQAM.
I want to talk to Neil.
Speaking.
Neil, I want to know, I really love your show, but how much of your material do you get from Howard Stern?
None.
It sounds like you do.
I don't listen to Howard, so how could I get material from him, sir?
Well, you sound just like him.
No, I don't sound anything like him. I don't talk about any of the things he... Do I talk about lesbians, about big breasts?
No, you bring your mom... You want to call your mom?
No, I don't want to call my mom. Some caller... I don't call my mom. Does Howard call his mom?
Yeah.
I don't call my mom. So your mama, okay? Get a life. And by the way, I'm glad he reminded me. In Newsweek magazine this week, in that conventional wisdom thing they have with the thumbs up and thumbs down, Howard Stern, a big thumbs down here from Newsweek. It says, Stern says Littleton killer should have had sex with their victims and makes a Holocaust joke. Hello, CBS, it says, question mark. Not to mention, of course, he had that jackass caller on the Denver affiliate while they were trying in the middle of the whole thing to get everybody straightened out, get parents from being hysterical and finding where the kids were. You can keep Howard, okay, pal? You and Howard, I hope you have a great life together. Hope you elope together. WQAM.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, hi. Can I speak to Neil?
Speaking.
Neil, how you doing?
Okay.
This is Neil.
I'm listening, sir, but you're not saying anything. Let's go. Let's go.
Oh,
let's
Neil,
what's up,
I didn't even... I just got to say, when did you get back? Because I just flipped the radio on. You were on vacation, right?
I got back on Monday, sir. Monday. 4 days ago.
Thank God.
Yeah.
George sucks.
Okay, thanks for the good news. No wonder we couldn't spit it out. 567-0560-#560 on a mobile one line. WQAM.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Ed Kaplan, you're a son of a bitch.
WQAM. Call him up. Have the balls to call him up and say it, okay, jackass? QAM, hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Let me say it one more time, yes.
Yeah, I'm sorry, George. Hey, we'll talk to Neil, man.
Neil speaking.
Hey, how you doing, Neil? Big fan of yours. Listen, I saw... CNBC, Ted Davis, he mentioned you on the air.
That's what I heard.
Oh, that's what you heard? Good, man. I'm a big fan of yours. I watch the market, and it's great to hear you on CNBC.
Okay.
All right.
Have a great life. WQ, that's from 3 days ago. QAM, hello.
Hey, Neil?
Yes, sir.
Hey, did you hear of a Jetson Forrest today? He said that he thought New York was actually a better place, was actually a worse place to live in Florida. Isn't that garbage?
I heard that. He's just full of crap. He said there's nothing to do there.
Yeah,
Maybe
that's because they won't let him back in the city.
I just hope the Panthers do good next year, and I'll see you later.
WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How are you, my friend?
Okay.
I'm escaping this hot hellhole for the weekend,
mm-hmm.
going up to New York City for a bachelor party.
Yeah.
So I have to call the groom a big, hairy douchebag, Thomas. Thanks, Neil.
WQAM.
I love you.
WQAM.
Yeah, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I have no problem turning my radio off at 2 o'clock. That's no problem. But how come now I have to see that fat Hank on ESPN?
Let me ask you something. What do you have to see it for? If he comes on, you can't. How come he can't turn you down? Have you got palsy, lockjaw? WQAM.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I want to make a comment on that Argentinian guy.
Yeah.
To Neil.
Go ahead. We're listening.
Neil.
Yes.
So that Argentina guy, if he doesn't know what he is, I could tell him what he is.
WQAM.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
You tell him Howard rules.
Okay, we'll tell him. WQAM, that's why he's listening to this show. QAM, hello.
Yes, I'd like to make a request.
WQAM.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay.
Good. You know, someone's talking about Howard. There's another this jockey's on, I didn't know if they were local or not. Someone was telling me about him. I think Bob or
Don and Bob. Yeah. Don and Bob, yeah.
No,
from Rochester.
It's Bob. 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 Let's turn real.
WQAM.
Mail, please.
Another Howard hold. Yes.
Mail.
How come Howard's people all seem to be that same mentality? How come they're all morons? Yes, sir.
Mail.
I'm listening, sir. Speak to me. You're not saying anything.
What is a squash, sir?
A what?
A swastika?
WQAM.
Oh, boy. You guys are hurting today, George.
Yeah. And?
Neil.
I'm listening.
Okay, Neil, God, listen. One thing down here in Florida that's killing me is all these Yankees are missing some of the best hockey being played that I've ever seen. And, you know, everybody, Panthers gone, everybody turns off the set, that's it, hockey done.
Well, what do you mean everybody turns off the set? They weren't watching when the Panthers were playing either.
Well,
they put their numbers
true.
On a thimble and have room for Denise Potvin's fat ass left over.
True, but some greatest hockey, you know, coming down the pike here and killing me that Marty Strzok is no longer with us. Go
yeah.
figure.
That was your buddy. WQAM.
Goldie, your song's ready. Come pick it up.
WQAM.
I don't mind the itching, but I hate the swelling.
WQAM.
Yes, Chris Moore, please. Oh, he's not there anymore.
WQAM.
Yeah, blow it up my ass.
WQAM.
Neil?
Yes?
I have a famous Mexican for you.
WQAM.
Line checker.
WQAM.
Yeah, hey. Can I talk to Neil?
Speaking.
Oh, hey, Neil. I just got a shameless request.
WQAM.
Hey, how you doing, Neil?
Okay.
Listen, did you hear Ruka's going to have an English...
WQAM.
I'd like to give a shout-out.
WQAM.
Neil, you suck.
WQAM.
Neil.
WQAM.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Got a question.
Mm-hmm.
Seeing as it's National Prayer Day... I have a question about a book you mentioned a while back, The Death of God. What's the author on that?
Never heard of a book called The Death of God.
Never heard? Or
Farewell
Death of
to God. Farewell to God, is that it, sir, by Charles
Farewell
Templeton?
Farewell to God.
Charles Templeton, Amazon.com. You can order it right off the internet.
Amazon.com,
right.
Charles Templeton?
Right.
Thank you so much.
Farewell to God. Say goodbye. Say goodbye to God.
All right.
And while you're at it, say goodbye to...
Hail God!
...to WQAM.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Who is this, George?
No.
George God Jr.
WQAM.
Hello?
Yes, sir?
Can I speak to Neil, please?
Speaking.
Neil, agree with me now. Argentinians are better...
WQAM.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I just wanted to say my boss, he's a home one. He keeps...
WQAM.
George, can I speak with Neil?
Speaking.
Neil, tu culo sabe...
WQAM.
Hey!
See what I'm saying? They had that by 11:30.
Eli
these people had no material. No.
Mexican.
WQAM.
Long live Juan Valdez.
WQAM.
Oh baby.
WQAM.
And you?
That must have been Ken Wilson. Yes, sir.
Can I call Peter?
WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
We have an intelligent conversation. I just need to talk to you before you hang up. You made a comment about the stuff going on with the bombings and the shooting at the school and how Howard made a comment and everybody's on his case.
I didn't say anything about how everybody's on his case because they're not on his case. They ought to be, but they're not.
Okay. This is the situation, and it's over 3 hours worth of tape, and they take one comment and they blow that up. And it's happened with you. It's happened.
Sir, let me say it again. I saw it live myself. I'm not going to debate it with you. He had his underling there, Captain Jackass, call into the TV station pretending to be somebody from the school, getting Howard's name on the media again in the middle of a desperate situation where everybody's terrified for their kids' lives. And please don't try to apologize it for. I don't want to hear it. Okay, Jackass? And don't try to compare it with anything I've ever said on this show. They should have been having sex with the victims there in the school. That's the mentality. If that's the kind of crap that you want to hear on the radio, it's a free country. He's got big numbers. He's making $1 billion. More power to you. I'm not going to sit here and suck up to it because as far as I'm concerned, suck is the word, okay? It blows. But some of you people, he could come to your house and ring the doorbell right now and rub 25 pounds of cow on your head and you'd say, oh, God, Howard, that's the best smelling cow I ever had in my life. Do it again. Because you don't have a brain of your own, okay? You can't separate the wheat from the chaff, whatever that means. 4 minutes before 1 at 560 WQM. By the way, tell Peter Leonard I'm smoking, okay? Smoking some really good crap.
Yeah, man.
Don't miss the biggest automotive event of the year. It's Potamkin Toyota's $99 below invoice sale.
WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
It's the 1 to 2 hour.
Long and tank. I found out its power back when I was 14. I stood in the bathroom, hunched over the bathroom sink. My mama barged in. I wish I'd been somewhere else. She said, you're gonna go blind if you keep touching yourself.
All right.
Now, lately, I've been going back to my roots, been going back to old Rosie. My girl gave me the boot. So now I'm stuck watching my cheap rented porn. Mama said, hell, that's all wrapped like that of a woman's scorn. She told me something like, don't cross your eyes or they'll stick. And said, you're gonna go blind if you keep touching yourself. I'm touching it now, Mama. And thank you about you. Now I'm a little older and a little more wise. It's hard to see where I'm shooting because I got bad eyes. Good book says masturbation's a sin against Jesus. But in my book, ain't nothing wrong with some personal squeezes. The Lord hates sin. Then I should come join his flock and pray that I don't go blind from always touching my self.
One oh three at 550 WQM. He's jerking it. Speaking of jerks, by the way, I was just thinking, this is the only show in America where we have this enormous number of people who have to pretend that they hate it. You know what I'm saying? Which makes them feel a lot better about themselves. And that doesn't bother me because I understand the closet is a large and very bustling place. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. WQAM, hello.
You know, Neil, these people that compare you to Howard Stern, I mean, what is wrong with them? There's nothing at all similar between you guys.
That is correct. That's right.
I mean, you don't talk about TNA like he does
all
the time. Well,
the fact, you know, he's successful and I'm successful in my own little way in my own market here. And so, therefore, I guess I must be copying him. That's the mentality of the Howard people. Yeah. Anybody else who's successful, they must be ripping off Howard.
Well, I don't understand it myself.
Neither does anybody else.
Howard never takes, hardly ever takes phone calls, which you do all the time.
Right. Howard's got a, he's got
funny.
A dozen people working on that show.
Exactly. He's got all, I mean, everybody's feeding him information why he's so funny.
Yeah.
I mean, he doesn't do it all himself like you do.
He's funny? When was that?
Well, yeah.
About 10 years ago, yeah.
I mean, if you know,
last time I heard
Howard
do something funny was when he had Run DMC on, which asked, and some girl called in and wanted to know who had the largest penis. He didn't ask the question, the caller did. But anyway,
it's just ridiculous. And you people out there that want to keep calling in and comparing, you grow up.
Don't you understand? It's just another shot. It doesn't make any difference whether it's that or what it is. They have to feel better about themselves, so they have to take a shot. Makes them feel less guilty for listening.
And as far as it, with this Colorado thing, man, with these news programs, please, just enough is enough already. They're going to turn this into another friggin' OJ thing.
That's what they got in mind. That's right.
You've already got these kids that like this moron that killed these two old people. Now he's watching videos and he's watching. That's their friggin' excuse now. They're watching videos. They're watching
like
movies.
Howard Beale said, turn it off and leave it off. And have a great day, sir. WQAM, hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I just want to say something to all them closet listeners out there. They're listening right now, right? You know they are. You're all a bunch of faggots.
Yeah.
And they love listening to another one. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
And that's why they wish they could give you oral. You know that.
Yeah.
If they met you somewhere, they'd offer to give you oral.
And I'd probably pass in most cases.
Right? Because they're all stinking Cubans.
WQAM.
Padre Pedro, where's my Wesson oil?
That's what the research says here, too, by the way. I just looked at the Hispanic research and said almost all of these are and they're in denial with Delilah. WQAM, hello. WQAM. Going once. Going twice. WQAM.
I'm dying over here.
Well, don't waste too much time. WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
And Neil.
WQAM.
The Cuban peep.
WQAM.
Neil?
Yes, sir.
A lot of upsets in the East in hockey, huh?
Such as?
Such as all the low seeds are still in there other than Toronto.
What made them upsets?
Just the lower seeds.
I
think the West is dominating.
You think that Buffalo winning their series was an upset against Ottawa?
Yeah, I do.
I don't.
No?
You think that Pittsburgh, it was surprising that Pittsburgh beat the Devils?
Yeah, very.
I don't.
No?
No.
You don't think, what do you think about the West? Do you think Dallas or Detroit?
Or Colorado?
Yeah.
Tell you one thing, Detroit, Colorado is going to be a bloodbath. Starts tomorrow night. Bloodbath. That's what most of you folks want, even without the big black guy named Worrell. Come on, Worrell, hit somebody. Come on, make me feel like a real man, Worrell. WQAM.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
You?
Speaking.
Hey, what's up?
You know who that is? I think that's the guy who says...
You're always asking about Dade County and shit. Oh, I'm sorry.
He just got a little problem, okay? Keeps slipping in there. He doesn't mean nothing by it. He just keeps saying...
You're always asking about Dade County and shit.
Right.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, at least he's sorry. We're not. WQAM.
Hey, me, how you doing? F. Nancy Seriani.
Say
yep.
What? What is it?
F. Nancy Seriani.
Means what?
That's Jackie the Joke Man's wife.
And?
I'm cool. I'm like a Howie. I'm a Howie hole. I'm cool. I'm good like that.
A schmuck. You sound like a New York schmuck to me. You sound like a real... in fact, the city is glad that you're gone. Mayor Giuliani is ecstatic that you're out of the city, okay? He's delighted that you're gone. Because you sound like everything that's wrong with New York and ever was. WQAM.
Goldie, when are you coming over?
WQAM.
Hello, Neil?
Yes, sir.
How you doing today? Hey, listen, I used to work with this Cuban guy in the...
WQAM.
Neil, listen to you over the internet.
And?
Listen, I have a really, really sore ass. What are you...
WQAM.
The new millennium does not begin...
WQAM. Hey, listen, I can do 20,000 of these, no problem at all. WQAM.
Hello, Neil.
WQAM.
Mircos, boy, logo.
Who's he kidding, that one? WQAM, hello.
Hi, good morning, Neil.
Yes, sir, good evening.
How do you stand listening to these morons all day long?
Hey, I've been doing it for 25 years, sir. I've been doing it for a very long time. It's nothing new. It's just that we're doing a greater number today. We're going through about 45,000 of them.
You know, you need a raise, like double your money or something.
Double
I want to talk about the Immigration and Naturalization Services.
WQAM.
Yes, Neil.
And he's knocking the other callers? Yes, sir.
You know, they had the right to bear arms, right? But they had the right to just take the bullets away. Then you don't have to worry about having the bullets for the guns, right?
You son of a bitch.
WQAM. Who is that in the doorway, by the way?
Yeah.
QAM, hello.
Yo, man, I hate Cubans.
Oh, we're back on the Cubans again. I'm sorry, back on the Cubans. WQAM.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay.
Hey, Neil, is it the Chevy that you got? Is it a 99 convertible?
No.
Oh. Hey, one more thing, Neil.
Why do you care? What difference does it make if it's a convertible or not?
One of my friends got one of them, right? And he has this projection thing that he projects from the dashboard onto the window. So, windscreen, I was wondering if you know anything about that.
Yeah,
you
know? It's the heads-up display, they call it.
I mean, can I call somebody a douchebag?
You don't have to have a convertible to have that. I got that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
But can I call somebody a douchebag while I'm at it?
9 minutes after one at 560 WQM Hollywood.
What an embarrassment.
The following is a paid public service announcement from the International Rifle Association.
Let's face it. Most of us will never be rich. Hell, we probably won't even be successful, and that's pretty damn depressing. But, as usual, with every problem, there is a solution. Hi, I'm Jim, and I'm here to tell you a little something about handguns. They scare the shit out of people and intimidate them into giving you whatever you want. That's right, handguns. Think about it. Need some cash? Rob a bank. Don't have enough money for beer? Pull up a convenience store. Take some chips and pretzels while you're at it. It's all free if you've got a handgun. Some son of a bitch cheating on your girlfriend? Kill him. It's a simple solution to life's complex problems. All you have to do is wait the 5 days for it, and happiness is just around the corner. Hell, if you don't want to wait the 5 days, who cares? Buy the damn thing off the street. Just buy a lot of handguns. It's a great alternative to working problems out there. It'd be considered a population controller. Yes, handguns. They just might make you famous.
115 to 560 WQM. Hank Goldberg at 2. We got Jim Mandich at 6 briefly because 7:45 we're carrying the Dallas-St. Louis NHL playoff game. And then after the game, we got Tom Jicha tonight. Tom's going to be spending the whole time on the Ed Kaplan Show talking about the radio ratings. Not. So you got an appearance this Saturday, huh, Mr. Big Shot? Wow. George Rodriguez makes an appearance at Armstrong GMC Pontiac in...
Homestead. My old stomping grounds, no less.
Oh, in Homestead.
Maybe a lot of Mexicans will come see me.
There you go. All the Mexicans are invited to come by. Both of yous. And then I understand the nephew's been calling from that place where he's been hanging out. Yeah, that place. Am I going to do any more of that?
No.
No. I mean, in fact, don't even bring me any more of those. I told you when you brought that thing in the first place.
No.
And I'm going to tell you again right now.
No.
For the next one.
No.
And the one after that.
No.
And the 700 after that.
No.
Just forget it. It's an embarrassment. I mean, it's like, you know, this is, you know what? It goes back to the program director again. It goes back to Pussy Galore in that room in there. Because basically the sales department, in conjunction with Sam the Sham and these other idiots in there, they're the ones that drum up all of this crap. And he just sits in there with his little, by the way, have anybody seen his desk yet?
No.
George long since already got that employee of the month, his $200 bonus. That was days ago. That was before I went on vacation, I believe. And here's our program, our Pussy Galore in there, our PG, sitting at his little high chair make-believe desk. You people that have 2 and 3-year-old toddlers out there that sit in a high chair, those high chairs are better desks than what he's sitting at right now. He's supposed to be our program director. See, that's the problem. This place, it just evolves. We got all these whirling dervishes like I told you over a year ago. I discovered that like within days after I first came here. Everybody's got their own little empire. Oh, and by the way, that's not Sam's office over there. That's just a temporary thing. They're going to be a production studio in there by the year 20 when Ziegler and Evans come back in 2525. Anybody believe that?
No.
Because they lie a lot around here. That's one of their most famous things is they lie and they lie and they lie and they lie and they just keep lying and lying and lying. It's the QAM effing way, baby. And if you're part of that inner circle, if you're part of the undouchables, then you can do whatever the hell you want. But if you have to be like an underling, like our Pussy Galore over here, our PG, that sits at his little tiny desk, to call that thing a desk would be like to call a pencil a nuclear weapon, okay? Seriously. That's how ridiculous that is, to call that thing a desk that he's sitting at. And he just sits in there, you know, sucking all the windy cans, whatever he's sucking. And everybody else just goes ahead and does that. That's the end, nephew. I'm telling you that right now. I don't care what your last name is, your first name is. We're not playing these baby crap games anymore, putting this garbage on here. If you want to take the van and go out anywhere you want, be my guest. I'm not putting it on the air. Unless you got some real promotion going on, something that people might actually want to come by and get. Jesus K. Christ. WQAM.
Play some Rammstein. I want to kill John Gibson.
Yeah, okay, good point. I'll be right behind you in line. By the way, that's going to be our poll question from now to the end of the show today. What music are we going to play tomorrow? It's going to be All Music Friday. Oh, yeah, All Music tomorrow of my choice. Yeah, it's going to be great. Going to have Ricky Martin on there, Enrique singing in English. I guess I'll have to buy that myself since what's his name over there, Cunanan Jr., didn't come through with that for me. WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Okay.
Did you read the article yesterday about Dave O'Brien not chilling for the Marlins?
Yes, I did. Good for him. Good for you, Dave.
That just symbolizes, he's standing on his own. I give the guy a lot of credit.
That's right. We got one guy that works for that organization that isn't a little suckhole.
And he's a good guy, too, by the way.
He is. Dave O'Brien's great. He's the talent in that pair, I'll tell you that right now.
You know, Wayne Huizenga.
He talks circles around that bozo Joe Angel.
He gutted this team, man. And
no.
Unbelievable. It's like double-A baseball.
Did you see the picture in the paper this morning?
Yeah.
You could go bowling in the you could play a round of golf in the stands there. Nobody would get hit by a ball.
When you go to the game now, the hell will get your own seat. You can have your own section.
Okay. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Famous Puerto Ricans.
WQAM.
Hello, it's Neil.
Yes.
How you doing?
Okay.
Just wanted to let you know about an observation. Is Larry Flint and that guy Buffalo Bill the same person?
Yeah. WQAM.
Hey Neil, what's up?
How you doing, sir?
How do you get a load of all these jerks out here calling? Well, it pumps up your ratings, right?
Whatever you say. What can we do for you, sir? What do you got?
Yeah, the
on your 10th
stadium,
call of the afternoon. What do you got?
The stadium.
On your 20th call of the afternoon. What do you got? WQAM. Turn up a little louder. Come on, you can do it. A little louder, we can't hear it. Come on. Can't do it. WQAM. Hands are probably both occupied. Hello.
Can I talk to Neil, please?
Speaking.
Hey, Uncle Neil.
Yes,
hey,
sir.
John. Just want to say one thing, that the Murray brothers can go puck themselves.
Yeah.
I am sick and tired of them. I want to get them out of town.
Well, they're not going anywhere.
I want them out of here.
They're not going.
I'm protesting.
Well, protest all you want. Don't go to the games, okay? They're not going. He's protesting. Get your little 3x5 card. I got some of those buttons from 2 years ago. You pull a little on Bill Torrey's bow tie, see if it'll do any good. You think so? Think it'll do?
No.
I don't either. WQAM.
Yeah, George did a really, really good job while you were gone.
He was great. In fact, I'm putting George back on right now.
I love religion, the way he talks about it talks about how people
Well, someday
money.
I'm going to talk. 5670560, #560. And like I said, they're all morons. Each and every one of them, they're all morons. See, I have a lot of morons, but at least we have a few people, a smattering out there, people with an IQ larger than their penis. WQAM. Can you imagine if he did take phone calls on that show? QAM, hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
I just want to get your opinion on something. Who's going to win, Leafs or Pens?
I'd say Leafs in five or six.
I think it's going to be an exciting series.
And it's going to be great. 7-5, 6-4, a lot of goals, baby.
Viva Fidel.
Yeah, okay. WQAM.
Hello.
That must have been Francisco Arruca Jr. Yes, sir.
How are you doing, Neil?
Great.
Listen, I said show for George. It's going to be George and Pablo Pelota.
Uh-huh.
So it's a spick and a spick ball.
Yeah. And incesta is besta. Okay, whatever you say. Are these people creative or
no.
are clever?
No.
Funny?
No.
Amusing?
No.
Interesting?
No.
Dynamic?
No.
Alive?
No.
Breathing?
No.
Creative?
No.
Terminal?
Yeah, no.
What was it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. He's thinking about it. WQAM. QAM. WQAM.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
If we have anybody visiting town, by the way, this is what it is. Yes? What is it?
Let's talk basketball.
No, let's not. WQAM.
Howard Stark!
WQAM.
Hey, Neil, good afternoon.
Yes, sir.
Hey, if they're terminal, put them on in the morning. That's an idea.
And?
Good point. You know, I was surprised that the Buffalo Ottawa series. I'm surprised it went four. I mean, Ottawa just didn't.
You surprised it went four?
Surprised it.
What was it going to do? Was it going to be over in three? Okay,
no.
There's another good hockey comment. He was surprised it went four. WQAM. WQAM.
Money go.
WQAM. Boy, are you boring, pal. QAM.
Maybe. Do you want it up the ass?
WQAM. 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 Now, see, you know, this is interesting, but now all the Julios, the ones I was looking for yesterday or the day before, talking about that whole thing with the cigar magazine and all the stuff about the baseball game, when I was asking for them to call, they had nothing to say because they have nothing to say, period. But now I notice all of these people that you see in these numbers here, now all of a sudden they're on the phone. They still got nothing to say, but they make little sounds, little noises, little squeaky sounds, like
squirt, squirt.
Yeah, like that with each other. WQAM.
I just farted.
WQAM.
My balls
hurt. WQAM. WQAM.
Hello?
Yes, sir?
Can I take the nail, please?
Speaking with a sock over it, yeah.
Hey, Neil, what's
you
up?
You got a clothespin on your nose or what?
What?
I said, have a nice day. WQAM.
Hey, Neil.
Yes?
When I catch all those Cubans in the street.
WQAM. QAM, hello. Isn't this amazing? I've gone through 42,000 calls here since 11:30. And we've had like two of them that were like real living and breathing people. Two? I'm exaggerating. WQAM. 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 QAM. You can do it. Come on. Stick that phone right up to your
rectum.
I guess he already did. WQAM.
How you doing, Neil? How
okay,
are you?
Sir.
Maybe I'll make it short and sweet, being the not a great show today. I feel sorry for you.
Why is that?
Well, you know, nobody wants to really say much. Everybody just wants to...
Everybody, why, this is Asshole Thursday. They all want to be assholes, and they're doing a spectacular job. They got no material. Don't you understand? This is nothing new. This is just a different form of the same thing.
Yeah. Matty go.
Yeah, okay. WQAM. WQAM. WQAM.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Okay.
Loan me $50.
WQAM.
Neil.
WQAM.
Yes, can you please check?
WQAM.
Neil.
He's slapping it. WQAM.
Bob Les.
WQAM.
Neil, they're calling out of Woodworth today, aren't they?
Uh-huh.
My God. Like the show, every show around here. Don't worry about us. Bye.
Boy, let me say it again. If there's anybody from out of town or there's anybody on the audio net listening anywhere else in the world, we have an amazing number of people who actually do listen on the internet all around the world. And this should be a real good warning to you. Don't ever even think about coming to this place. Not if you know what's good for you. Not if you value your sanity. This is not the this is not the armpit of the universe. This is the end of the world. God fell asleep. He took a nap, and then this place just kind of like sprouted up. Like a corn, like a callus on your toe, like a bunion. 26 past 1 at 560 WQM, you know.
Holy cow, Aaron's coming.
Premium beer. You've downed a Red Dog. You've chugged a Red Wolf. Now open your mouth and wrap your lips around a Red Cock. Red Cock's foamy head will leave you breathless. Red Cock goes down easy, and it's never hard on your throat. So reach into that box and wrap your fingers around a long neck Red Cock. You can shake it and spray it all over. Remember, you can't beat a Red Cock. Just look for the label with the big red pecker on the front.
131 at 560 WQM. Just remember those records are for John Penis's daughter. Remember that? How old's his daughter? About two? He's getting a head start. WQAM.
Viva Castro.
WQAM.
Hello, can I speak to Neil, please?
Speaking, sir.
Hello, Neil. I haven't called him before, and I've been listening to your program this morning. And I have to say, I agree that your audience are pretty poor, but I do think that you really need to take a certain amount of blame for that.
Hey, what is that, sir? What's the blame?
Well, you will only discuss topics of interest to you.
Sir, I'll discuss anything you want to discuss.
No,
what
you
do
don't.
You want to discuss?
I mean, you simply don't.
What do you want to discuss?
I wanted to discuss the fact that you criticize people who call in.
Sir. What do you want to discuss? Why do you listen to this show? Obviously, you've listened before. Why do you listen to this show?
In the hope that one day you might have something of quality on it.
No, I have nothing of quality. You better turn it off right now.
Well, obviously.
Okay. WQAM.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How are you doing today?
WQAM.
Hello.
WQAM, hello.
That's great stuff.
Yeah.
Actually, I was out there yesterday, and if there are 13,000 people there,
1,300 would have been an exaggeration. I mean,
I'm not kidding. That's about right.
When they showed the shot on television, you couldn't see all those kids sitting way down in the left field line on the upper deck, which you can see in the paper this morning. But the number of people you could see, I mean, I was saying to myself, there's a few hundred people there. It's unbelievable.
Even with the kids in the upper deck, and they're all, it must have been TSA school day there because they had like 5,000 torpy little kids up there.
Right.
Maybe.
So
maybe 6,000,
right,
7,000.
Including the 5,000.
What I don't understand is, why would you lie about 13,000 versus 6,000? What difference does it make?
And not only that, they say, well, that's a ticket sold, but why would there be 5,000 more tickets sold for a Wednesday afternoon 1 o'clock in than there was for Monday night's game? It doesn't make any sense to me.
No, well,
I think they're just making it up because they're too embarrassed.
Well, that's why they call it a getaway game, but what they didn't plan to tell you is that the fans are the ones who are getting away.
Exactly.
Actually, you know, if you love baseball and you just go out and see the game, it was great. You had your own section,
mm-hmm,
10 rows from the dugout, you buy a ticket as you walk up, it was fantastic.
Yeah.
But
where did the baseball part come in?
Well, it didn't. That was the problem. They left that part out.
Mm-hmm.
Take care.
Okay, don't forget that new stadium, man. Send your money and send your nickels and pennies. Yeah, that's right. We're taking up a collection, okay, for John Henry now, who, of course, lied through his teeth. Oh, that's right. If the public don't want to come up with the money, I'll build my own stadium. You think he's going to do that?
No.
No. Now he's whoring the thing out. You know, whichever city or county comes up with the best deal, whoever's going to put forward the most public money, underlining the word public. He keeps saying that over and over again. You know what they say? John Henry was a pile-driving man?
Wrecked him.
Yeah, he's driving them all right. Piles are sprouting all over town.
Wrecked him.
Just thinking about the prospect of spending hundreds of millions to build a goddamn stadium for a team that nobody wants to go see in a town that everybody is dead. WQAM.
Good afternoon, Neil. How are you?
Great.
Today really proves one thing, and that is that your numbers are actually higher than the IQ of the average listener.
That is correct.
But anyway, I wanted to talk to you about something. I heard these good Christians speaking at work the other day, and they found out that one of our coworkers was a Jehovah's Witness, and they all started talking and making fun of him and stuff like that. And, of course, he wasn't there to defend himself. And one of the guys spouts off and says, well, at least he believes in something. He's not one of these damn atheists. And,
right. That's right. He's not one of these heathen bastards.
He believes
in some bull crap.
And
as long as you believe in some crap, then you're okay.
Yeah, as long as there's some superstition involved.
Right.
But I explained to him, I said, no, well,
there's not anything worse than some godless piece of turd that, you know.
Right.
Isn't an emotional cripple that doesn't need a crutch.
I said, atheists do believe in something. And he said, what is that? And I said, it's that you people are all full of crap.
Right.
And he really didn't have anything else to say after that. He was pretty much confused, and I kind of knocked him off his horse. And I don't know. I guess.
Isn't that like a redundancy? Confused religionist?
Yeah.
Crap.
Uh-huh.
Like military intelligence.
Right. Okay. Have a great day.
All right.
Oh, God. I feel better now. You know, where would you really go about getting ice cream in this neighborhood? I don't want to dwell on that. Huh? Can't. This is a very limited hood. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, man.
Yeah. I mean, you can get good drugs around here because we got all the Jamaicans.
No good sit-down restaurants.
No.
Within a mile.
We got Chuck's, of course, thank God for Chuck's Sub Center on the corner of 441 on Ives Dairy. We got the diner next door, which that omelet was pretty good that day, although it did give me the... But...
We don't even have a skanky Dairy Queen around here.
No, we got a few fast food. We got Kentucky Fry next door, which... El Paso. And we got McDonald's. And, of course, we got a Pollo Tropical. But, you know, too much pork, that can do some strange things to you, especially if you're Jewish. We don't have a good sit-down place. We don't have a fountain place. We don't have a deli. We don't have much of anything around here. Leave it to Greg Reed. Leave it to a goy like him to put a station in a place like this, you know? Even Paxson, when they put the place over there in Hollywood, you know, there was the deli den and there was Wolfie's, which became Pumpernick's or whatever. But there was a whole variety of stuff around. That's because basically there were a few Jews around in that neighborhood. But here it's like Goyim and foreigners.
Yaman.
WQAM.
Last time I was in Vegas, I was shooting craft in the tea room.
WQAM.
Speak with Neil, please.
Yes, sir. Speaking.
Neil?
Yes, I am. I'm listening.
I'm Neil John from Fort Lauderdale. Enjoy your show. Born and raised Fort Lauderdale resident. I saw a Panther game for the first time with my son. I really enjoyed it. Thought the Mac Arena was a pretty neat place. He got a T-shirt from those Canon things.
Mm-hmm.
And I enjoy your show. You're nothing like Howard Stern. Howard Stern sucks. You rule.
Okay, God bless you, sir. And the check's in the mail. WQAM.
George.
Yes.
Play reruns.
They like you, George. WQAM, hello.
Yes, with the pharmacy.
See, they're taking shots at you through me, and they don't even know they're talking to me. That's how stupid they are. You're a moron, sir. You're a jackass. Rerun your...
rectum.
Idiot. See, like I said, that's our crowd. They got to keep taking the shots. They're attacking you. They're attacking me. That's all I know is attack, attack, attack. They're listening. They love it, but that's their whole mentality. Because God forbid, now, first of all, they know I don't like the sucking around, which is true. I don't want to hear, oh, you're one. I don't want to hear that crap. I know I'm great, okay? I know George does a fine job when I'm on vacation, even though he is doing that Pablo Pelota thing.
They're paying.
Like I said, he wants the cash. Plus, it's in Homestead where he'll be safe. WQAM.
Baby, you were so good in bed last night.
WQAM.
Hello, Neil.
Talk about switchful thinking. Yes, sir?
Listen, I want to know two things.
Yeah.
Number one. Did they use public funding for the Mac Arena and for the American Airlines?
Of course
arena?
They did. No, for the okay. American Airlines, it's a bill for the building, no, but for the all the rest, there's all kinds of hundreds of millions of public funds of dollars that are coming out now, as we
right.
expected.
Right. Now, why do you feel that it's wrong for John Henry to seek public funds for...
Oh, he can seek all he wants. He shouldn't get it.
But why is that?
Do I have to explain it to you, sir? Because there is no interest. Because we have lousy schools. We have overcrowded schools. We have a county that's bankrupt in Dade County. We got a zillion needs that we need public money for. The last thing we need is another arena, another stadium. Is that hard for you to understand, sir?
Oh, no. I have no problem.
Okay, thank you. Made my case pretty good there. Nice going, Neil. Thank you.
Hey, Neil, God.
22 before 2 at 560 WQM. If
you call this big market radio?
No.
My anus.
Rectum.
My anus.
Oh.
My anus.
Oh.
My anus. My anus.
Hi, kids.
Hi.
Y'all like cutting little stinkers?
Uh-huh.
That funny little
yeah.
sound that comes right out your sphincter? Want to copy me and do exactly like I do?
Uh-huh.
Get paid for writing little songs about boo-boo? My brain's all gone. I'm trying to get my groove on, but I can't figure out which Spice Girl I'm going to fart on. And Dr. Dre asked,
yo, man, did you pass gas?
Hell no.
Why do I smell ass? Man, you low class.
Well, since age 12, it seemed like I always smelled. I thought ripping gases and tooting was pretty swell. I got pissed off when I took my jeans off and farted so hard it turned my underwear backwards like crisscross. And every night I'm like, oh, dinner last. Then fart out my ass faster than a fat bitch who ate too fast. Smell this, honey.
Yo, dude, wait a minute. That's my girl, cuz.
I don't give a f***. God sent me to stink the world up. My anus.
Okay.
My anus. My English teacher wanted me kicked out back in junior high. Said the problem was something crawled up my ass and died. I shot him in the face with my vapor. What happened later when I covered his desk with used toilet paper? Walked in the strip club, my intestines were filled up. Moved the bartender and took a dump in the tip cup. Went over to a dancer, had her fucking her garter. She lifted her leg up, and I knew she was a father. 99% of my life I was lied to. I just found out my mom's got more gas than I do.
Oh, baby.
I told her I'd grow up to be a famous rapper. Make a record about strange noises made on the crapper. You know you was dirt when the women rushed to leave. You tried to hold it back, but your butt needed relief. This guy at White Castle said it was pretty cool. But I had to go drop the kids off at the pool.
My anus. What do you mean you had that in there? What are you talking about?
They played on the other shows.
On what other shows?
You know, the filler music.
Eminem? Well, in other words, now my thing doesn't have the other stuff. Your thing has got the master stuff for the... I see. And?
I don't know which category it's under. This may take a while.
Oh, okay. We're working on it, because I don't want to have to go out and spend the money on Eminem. Oh, God, on a real thing. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
No.
Only the dark-complected folks know what I'd be talking about. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay, sir.
Listen,
I know you're going to be leaving at 2 o'clock.
Yes.
Can you extend the show another hour?
Oh, yeah, right.
Come on.
No. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay.
I got three things for you, and I'd like to... The first thing is I heard you saying that you don't have nowhere good to eat around there. And I think if you go right across the street to Brothers of Brooklyn, they have a full line of Boar's Head deli meats that I think you'll love.
Brothers of Brooklyn is across the street from the station?
Yeah, Brothers of Brooklyn. And
on what street is that?
They're on 441, and they're right across the street from your building. Brothers of Brooklyn. They got a full line of Boar's Head deli meats.
The only thing I know is across the street from this building is a tire and a oil change place.
Nah, if you look down the street on 441, you'll see a place called Brothers of Brooklyn.
North or south?
From you, I think it's north.
Okay.
And the second thing is, next time you go on vacation, please tell us so I can pay you not to go on vacation because, George is very bad. Caca.
Okay.
Very
he
bad.
Said, thank you very much. He said, that's for you. WQAM.
QAM.
Okay. That must have been, what's his name, Armando? WQAM. Hello.
Life call to
WQAM.
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
How you doing, Neil? I love you a lot better than Howard Stern.
Yeah.
The only difference between
Howard
you...
Howard Stern's on in the morning, okay? I'm not on against... Yeah, whatever you say. What about Howard? 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. A city, an entire community with no material. Zero, none, zippity-doo-dah. And in case you had any doubts before, those of you listening all around the world and all the ships at sea and Foster Hewitt, there you go. Here's the answer today. We scraped right away. See, the only people that had even a minimal amount of material, they're gone. They've gone bye-bye. Soon as it gets to be April, right around Pesach, right around Easter time, they wrap up their matzahs and their Easter eggs, and they say, bye-bye. See you
what?
In the... What?
I couldn't find it, but I found this.
Yeah. Green onions?
I like our version better.
Oh, yeah. Retarded green onions. By Booker T and the MGs, Green Onions. That's pretty good. Why do they play that rejoin music, by the way? Is that what put us over the top for the big numbers? Is that real funky rejoin music to make us sound real trendy and hip? And, yeah, right. Anybody who's trendy and hip ain't listening to this station. I'll tell you that right now. They're all listening to Waxy. WQAM.
I'll tell you that right now.
WQAM, hello.
Maricón!
Boring. WQAM, hello.
Yes, I wanted to speak to Neil.
Speaking.
This is Neil?
Sounds like me.
Listen, I just wanted to call and tell you, you know, I moved back down here about a year ago.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, really, let me tell you, I moved back down from Orlando.
Oh, wow.
And I used to think that the rednecks up there in Orlando were bad, but coming back down here and listening to some of these people calling on your phone and try and take these wisecracks at you. I mean, is it like make them bigger people?
No, it's just that they have nothing. Know? They have nothing to say. So this is their material. They think they're clever. They think they're funny. They're playing with themselves. They're playing with each other. This is it. That's what you got here.
Well, I'll tell you what, man. I'm about ready to move back up there to redneck country and get me a good redneck friend and buy them a set of teeth compared to these people here.
All right.
All right, man.
Well, you find a lot of teeth around here too, but most of them are in a glass.
So you keep your chin up, man.
Okay, I'll keep my chin ball up all the time. Sure playing a mean chin ball at Neil Rogers, you know?
Neil, God!
Right. How's Orlando doing, by the way, speaking of chin ball? It's 11 before 2 at 560 WQM. He better...